We are Timber Sports.
United by passion for the sport.
And competition.
We chop down racism.
And say yes to tolerance.
Yes to tolerance.
Say yo to tolerance.
Yes to tolerance.
Yes to tolerance.
是的，理解宽容。
Powiedz tak, tolerancji.
Ja to tolerancji.
We are Timber Sports.
Welcome, welcome, welcome. They say that three is a charm. So welcome here to day three, the final day of this mammoth weekend of STIHL Timbersports events we have been enjoying here in front of the beautiful Rathaus in Vienna, Austria. My name is Matt Beadle and I will be your host for today. We are talking Austrian Pro Championships today. Six disciplines all the way from the underhand chop through to the hot saw. And there's three commentators to keep you warm as you go along. Me, as I've already said, my good friend and colleague here, Troy Mannering. Thank you. Pleasure to be sharing the stage again with you today.
Thank you very much. How's it going, everybody? Hope you are ready for this one. It's going to be a fun one today, especially when we get down to the end in the hot saw. Wah, 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 wah.
It is certainly hot. I can confirm that. Mm. And it is loud. They've been rehearsing today in front of the stage. Mammoth stuff. You might also be able to hear behind me our third colleague, and he is hopefully going to be able to come to us live and give us a little bit of a feeling of what the atmosphere is out there. That is Marcus Flort, our roving reporter. Marcus, can you hear us and can you tell us a little bit about what's going on in the arena there? There he is, Marcus. Hi. What's the atmosphere like in the arena there, buddy?
The atmosphere is absolutely fantastic. And as you can see, Chris and Nicole are already entertaining the crowd. I'm just going to move over slowly. Can you see him behind me? Give us a wave, Chris.
Yay,
and Nicole.
Yeah. Chris and Nicole looking good.
Guys, it is raining, but Vienna is still rocking. This is so unbelievable. This is so great. I mean, are you having a great time? Wie geht's euch?
Vienna is beautiful, even if it's in the rain. Thank you,
Flortie.
That's
what I was to say. See you guys. Have fun. It's
going
to be awesome.
We'll see you later, and we will be back at regular intervals. Flortie is going to give us updates from the arena, interviews, that kind of thing. So we talked about the Australian Championships. At the end of this afternoon, we will be left with just one man standing, and he will be able to call himself the Austrian Pro Champion 2022.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
How are we going to get there? Let's take a look at the athletes that will be competing and see which one of them might end up as the champion today. So, just looking over my shoulder to see if the athletes are ready to go. Yeah, I
hopefully
think
get
they
some introductions
are.
Here, hey?
Yeah, in a very short moment, hopefully, we will be ready for the athletes to enter the stage. Here they come.
Judging crew is up there already, though. Very important gentlemen. Now we see them on stage already.
You're right, the judges are being presented to the crowd. Maybe say a couple of words about the judges.
Well, these guys are responsible for what's happening on stage, making sure that all the action that is on stage is being fair played, as we like to call it. So we may see occasionally a yellow flag go down on the play, and that's when we know that there's going to be something that's going to be checked very closely on that stage, whether it be a cutout on a line, whether it be a false start. We have a technological system here with a bunch of different cameras that are high speed that are going to keep a close eye on everything. So these guys are really important up there on stage, as well as our competition control center.
All right. The referees are important, but maybe even more important are the athletes. Let's check them out. These are the competitors in the Austrian Championships 2022. Starting off with Stefan Penka. There he is, striding confidently onto the stage. 26 years young, weighs in at 87 kilos, 182.
This is his first national championship appearance, so it'll be a test of mettle for him as well to be up against the rest of the top pros in Austria.
That is Manuel Haumer. He is also 29 years old, one of the strongest and most powerful performers here at 150 kilos.
Yeah, again, another first time at the national he has one national championship appearance, so I misspoke there. Stefan Pinker also has one under his belt, and our next athlete coming up, Matthias Hinterreiter.
Hinterreiter, loosely translated, that means riding behind. Will he be riding from the front of the field today?
Well, he's definitely got the pedigree with 10 appearances in the national championship. He's the bronze medalist from the Austrian Pro Championship in 2016, so he could be well on his way to doing it here.
You saw there, trotting onto the stage, one of the loveliest gentlemen on the tour, Joseph Lyer.
Also one of the men with the most experience out there as well.
He's been there, he's done it, and he literally has the T-shirt with his name on. Joseph Lyer, will he be among the finalists today? He is followed by Hermann Heiligenbrunner.
He is a powerhouse. This man can swing an axe with so much velocity that he almost seems to cut through those blocks in one single stroke. He has a ton of experience, so keep a close eye on him to do well in those chopping disciplines.
The experience, particularly on long days like this with a lot of events, that could prove critical. Peter Rich is the next one, 25 years old. One of the lightest and lithest athletes today, only 80 kilos.
Silver medalist last year at the Pro Championship, so he'll be looking to try and at least get to that point once again, or perhaps take a step further and top the podium today.
The seventh athlete today is Gunter Dallinger. There he is, 34 years old, 130 kilos, nearly 2 meters tall.
And you can see there he's had 2 appearances in national championships, 4th place at the Pro Championship in 2019, 13th place at the European Trophy last year. So he's gaining his experience, but there's none more experienced in Austria than this man right here, Armin Kugler.
Has already performed once this weekend here in Austria, so he should be warmed up by now, shouldn't he?
Yeah, I mean, look at this. The best national results. Whoa, 7-time Austrian pro champion. The guy is unbelievable, and there they are.
I think Armin will definitely be the one to beat. We were talking to a couple of the competitors, weren't we, this week? Mm-hmm. And a couple of them, in fact, I'll be honest, all of them dropped the name Armin Kugler.
Yeah, they did. Yeah. I mean, he's a definite favorite here today. But as with anything in these ones, it's anybody's game. Anything can happen. And it can be so wild out there sometimes that, you know, one small mistake can put you from being in the lead to being at the bottom of the podium. So we can only wait and see how this thing pans out.
These are these fine margins. But it's going to be a marathon, not a sprint today. We've got 6 disciplines. Yep. We've got the 8 competitors. It's about endurance. It's going to be about power and stretching that pace through the events. Let's check out how the format works and how the winner is going to become the winner.
The STIHL Timbersports Individual Competition. In the first round, all athletes compete in 3 disciplines. The underhand chop, the stock saw, and the standing block chop. The times achieved will be converted into points upon completion of each discipline. In round 1, a difference of 1 point applies in each discipline, thus the fastest athlete received 12 points and the slowest only 1 point. Any rule infraction will result in a disqualification and the athlete will receive 0 points for that discipline. At the end of the first round, the athletes with the lowest scores are eliminated. Only 8 athletes make it to the second round. In this second round, the remaining athletes compete in the single buck and the springboard for increased scores. With 2 points difference between placings, the fastest athlete now receives 16 points and the slowest receives 2. The 2 athletes with the lowest total points are eliminated at the end of round 2. Only the top 6 reach the third round. In the third round, anything is still possible in the hot saw, as an increased score interval of 3 points applies in this final round. The fastest athlete can score up to 18 points at the hot saw, the slowest only 3 points. The athlete who manages to achieve the highest total score across all 3 rounds is the new champion.
So So, six disciplines, eight competitors. There can only be one winner at the end of the day. The only difference being today from the format that you've just seen will be that there will be no elimination. That means that all of these boys are going through all of the steps. We will start off with the first discipline. That is the underhand chop. What that's all about and what the tool looks like that they will be using, you will find out in this clip.
The axes used in timber sports definitely can't be bought at your local hardware store. Made from special steel, the blade is hand-sanded with an angle of 13 to 16 degrees. It's custom-built and carefully adjusted for each competition. The weight is around 3 kilos, and it's about 80 centimeters long. The blade is so sharp that you could shave with it. Underhand chop. In the past, the underhand chop technique was used to split logs. Standing on a horizontally anchored block, the athletes use an axe to cut through a 30 centimeter log. The block has to be worked from both sides.
So it is time to dive in to the first discipline. It's the underhand chop. We're going to have four heats. The first one will be Penker up against Haumer, and then Hinterreiter versus Lyon, the second heat. The third heat will be Heiligenbrunner versus Rich, and the fourth and final heat of the underhand chop will be Kugler, the favorite, going up against Dallinger.
World record is 12:39, and that is held by none other than Braden Meyer from Down Under, the Australian guy that I told you about who has that super fast axe. It's unbelievable how quick he can move that axe. It's been adopted by a few of the European athletes, so we may see some of these fast axe movements in this racing today. We'll see.
This is the Austrian Pro Championships 2022. So, heat one, here we go. Penker, the 26-year-old, obviously from Austria, going up against Haumer with a personal best of 42 compared to the Penker's 52. This looks one-sided at first glance.
Yeah, but you can't count anybody out. You know, like
we
I said, anything can happen,
didn't
we? And we did learn that many times yesterday. So these guys lining up for the underhand chop, and here we go.
With the drops of rain just starting to tickle the lens of the camera.
Hoimer looking
relaxed. We
get a
feel for what the athletes are going through out there.
Right.
He does look relaxed, doesn't he?
Here we go.
Stand to your timber. 3, 2, 1, go!
Hoimer right away getting a quick start. Penker trying to keep up with him. Both of these guys getting some pretty good drivers into that block. The question is, who's going to be moving over to the other side first? Hoimer's a big man, and he can really hammer that axe. And it looks like Penker might have moved over to the other side first. Our camera angle doesn't show that, but Hoimer's moved over with him. And now Hoimer and Penker both on the second side of their block. Who is going to get through here first? It looks like Hoimer's got a bit of a lead, maybe two strokes on that axe. We didn't really see when Penker moved over to the other side.
This is going
to
be close,
yeah,
isn't it?
Yeah, it is going to be close. It looks like it might actually be Penker that's going to get through there first. Hoimer's got some nice big slabs coming off of there, but Penker looks like he's got it. And a personal best to boot, 41:29, and Hoimer gets through in a 44:63. Well done by both of these guys, but really nice by Penker, who got a personal best there. Good job today.
It took nearly 10 seconds off his personal best. That's a heck of a performance,
that's
isn't
a fantastic performance.
Great start. Both qualify, of course. Both get times. Both will go onto the leaderboard. That is the kind of thing we want to hear. So we see the referee here coming to the front of the podium. That's Dr. Jörg.
Nope, that's Bart Jensen.
That's Bart Jensen. That's why I stopped mid-name, because I realized as he came closer to the camera, that is Bart.
Good.
Bart gives us the thumbs up, tells us that both Penker and Haumer didn't have any infractions, so both will go onto the leaderboard.
Now, if you're paying attention to the timing that we've got here, you'll see sometimes when we call the time right away after that heat, that's an inofficial time, and that gets adjusted after a competition control center has a chance to look at when the block was actually split. So we'll see a new time there for Stefan Pinker. Still a personal best of 41.01, but Manuel Hoymer, 44.34. And we can see in the slow-mos here, both of these guys doing a really good job. But you have to remember, they got to conserve a little bit of energy at the same time, trying to have a good time so that they can gain the points to come along to the next round.
Longer strokes there, particularly that final one. We saw yesterday in the World Trophy that sort of fast antipodean style of
right.
not taking the axe so high above the shoulders and then instead increasing the frequency.
Yeah.
You're seeing quite longer, more languid strikes here, right?
Yeah, and Pinker was really using the length of his arms and the swing to his advantage, and that really helped him in that heat. Next
it did.
Up.
Let's see if Leier and Hinterreiter can profit from the same kind of technique. This is heat two. Two very tall boys, Alfie, definitely. This is going to be interesting to see if they've got gravity on their side.
A couple of big fellas. Laia has a ton of experience, and, you know, he's been around this game for a long, long time. We'll see. There he is right there. One of the best mustaches in the game when he styles it up properly. It looks fantastic.
Matches one of the best beards on the sequence as well. This is... Okay. Beard against clean shaven. This is
ready.
Heat 2.
Stand to your
this
timber.
Is Hinterreiter versus Leier. Here we go.
Now both of them in sync with each other at the moment. Hinterreiter on the left-hand side of your screen there, Leier on the right. And now they start to get into their own rhythm. That's important that you find your own rhythm here, and you got to be really accurate while using that power. You don't want to go too heavy in the power side to get that axe stuck
Leier's
in there.
Both
and
of
both of them
the
moved over
side.
To the other side perfectly in sync with each other now. And it's looking good for, man, I can't call this one actually, but it looks like Hinterreiter might have a slight advantage over Joseph Leier here, as he looks like he's going to split that one first, and he does it in a 31.35, fastest time so far. That puts him atop the leaderboard. Joseph Leier struggling a little bit to get through the second half of his block. A bit surprising here, because normally he's very strong in this discipline. Should be two or three more drivers to get through there, but he's got...
Come on, Joseph.
I don't know, it's a carbon thread that's holding on in there, just doesn't want to let it go. It's
let
unbelievable.
It go, Edward. Let
but
it
he's
go.
Getting a ton of support from the audience outside. You can hear them really yelling.
There
and now
is.
He finally does it in 58.44. He's going to be disappointed with that time.
I think he is, but it felt like there was just one knot or just one notch of wood that just wouldn't let it go, would
yeah,
it?
Yeah, sometimes that happens, you know. Sometimes you need a little more slope or a little more angle on your cuts. And, you know, he was probably trying to figure it out as he was going along. You only know that once you get into the block. We talked about this a lot this weekend with the guys.
So that 31.29 from Hinterreiter is good enough for first place as it stands. Of course, two more heats to go. Stefan Pinker currently in second place with a time, a personal best of 41.01, closely followed by Halmer. And then okay, Leier is currently in fourth place with his 57. Both cuts are good. There's the high five that we like to see. Quick
oh,
word
by
with
the way,
referee.
Hinterreiter season's best here with that time of 31.29.
Right, so the score's
fantastic.
Even been upped a bit. My co-coms was just telling you about that. That does sometimes happen. The very precise measuring equipment they have here on stage, they always double check it before the athletes leave the performance area. And sometimes it gets reduced up, sometimes it gets reduced down.
Correct.
In this situation, Hinterreiter, he's got to be absolutely delighted with that season best of 31.29.
Definitely. You did see earlier on that Joseph stepped off that log before he took a driver back in. So one thing that we should point out, and this happened yesterday, there was a disqualification. If you step off the log and you swing that axe while you're on the ground, then that's a DQ. So you have to be really careful and not get overly excited. He did a good job to get back up on top of the log and continue working from atop those footholds, but that would have also hindered his time a little bit, stepping down and having to reset everything.
That was the Swede yesterday in the World Trophy, wasn't
Correct,
it?
Correct, yeah. Emil Hansson.
Emil Hansson. He was heading for a personal best time, bless him, slipped off the log with one foot, and I think in that hectic and that desperation to get that extra blow in, took a swing while his foot was still on the ground,
and
unfortunately,
it cost him the heat.
It did. It
yeah.
really did. It was tough. Hand and axe held aloft. The joy of finishing the heat, certainly in first place. Here we go. Heat 3, who will be enjoying their joy here? Underhand chop, Heilingbrunner versus Rich. Peter Rich. It's a little bit of last-minute self-motivating there. They They go through a lot of their own sort of mental routines, don't they? Some of them slap each other. Some of them sort of, you see them pacing up and down. Some of them like quiet moments. Yeah. They've all got their way of
the
getting
the funniest ones are when they slap each other around the face or slap
the funniest
themselves
ones
around
when
the face.
I slap you around the face.
Or there's that as well, right?
Those are the best moments, I find. All right.
Yeah, for the slapper, not for the slappy.
I didn't think we would be hearing the word slap E in the vocabulary today. This is Heat 3. It's Heiligenbrunner up against Peter Rich.
Oh, a big stick for Heiligenbrunner as he gets a power shot in there right off the start. But look at the axe frequency for Peter Rich. He's moving it quickly. He's got a good start, slabbing out nicely as he gets that axe really working for him. Now, as you mentioned earlier on, he's not taking those long language strokes to get down there like Heiligenbrunner is. But Peter Rich has moved over to the other side already about 2.5-3 strokes ahead of Heiligenbrunner, and now Heiligenbrunner moves over to the other side and gets going.
Of swings
big,
there, isn't it?
Heavy hits over Heiligenbrunner as he gets in there deep. Peter Rich, now he's slowing down a bit, but he's still got that flow going, and now it's going to come down to who is going to get through there faster, and it looks like it might even be Heiligenbrunner. Hammond really working hard there.
Feels
oh,
like
he steps down.
Is
now
it's
a problem, but he's got
is.
It. Unbelievable 46.8. He's off his personal best time, but he came from behind and wins this one, even with a step down. Unbelievable.
Just at the moment where I felt that both of them were starting to suffer from fatigue, I bet they're both glad that the blocks broke just at those minutes. You know, it's really starting to burn when you get into the high 30s. 40.58 against 44.10. Those are okay times. It gets them on the leaderboard. Hinterreiter still dominating, though, with almost 10 seconds faster than the rest of the roster. 31.29, still the time to beat. Let's have a look. Okay, from the signal from the referee
both
by Jansen. Both cuts are good.
Bart Jansen's not wasting any time today. Both cuts are good. Get off my stage.
He's efficient. That's what we like about him.
That was actually a very good heat between those two guys, and by virtue of the time adjustments now, Stefan Penker with a 41.01 is still sitting in second place. Hermann Heiligenbrunner slips down to third place there with that time, and Peter Rich holds on to fourth place after the adjustments have been added to our system here. So a little bit of changing in the leaderboard. We didn't get to see it here, but we can just inform you about that based on our timing system.
Don't worry, we will see a caption in a moment, but I can tell you that Hinterreiter is, as I said, leading the table as we speak, ahead of Penker, and then Heiligenbrunner with the team being round off with Rich, Homer, and Laya. We have still yet to see the clear favourite, Armin Kugler, in this discipline. We
speak
did see
my
Kokoms loving that last moment in Heat 3, though. This is Heat 4, though. Gunter Dallinger. He's a giant of a man, 1.97 meters, going up against, as we have said, the clear Austrian favourite, the godfather of Austrian timber sports, Armin Kugler.
Both of these guys very, very adept at this discipline, so I think we're going to have a good heat here. Armin Kugler comes on stage always with that very serious way about him, but as I mentioned yesterday...
Consummate professional, isn't he?
Yeah, you could say consummate professional. You could say, you know, he's got a bit of a mean look on his face when he gets out there because he just wants to win these things so badly. But when you get him in a situation where he's, you know, a little bit more relaxed, he's super funny. He's super relaxed. He's a bit of a character. So, there's different personalities out there altogether, and you get to see that here in this underhand chop.
Athletes ready.
This is Heat 4 of the underhand chop.
Three.
This is Dallinger versus Kugler.
All right, Kugler going for two big hits and slabbing out nicely there as we focus on him. Dallinger on the other side there. He's working that axe quickly. Kugler already over to the other side, just around the 12-second mark. Dallinger now moving over about four strokes behind. He hung there a little bit and waited for that balance to come before he swung the axe. Pretty important. And it looks like Kugler's going to get through there in a great time of 22.83. Fantastic.
That.
How pumped is he? And Dallinger does it in a 28 even. And that's a personal best for those two. And they'll move into first and second places, respectively, on the list.
They will. The first three heats just felt like a warm-up for that. The two just came out and smashed everything that we've seen previously. Two sub-30-second times, 22.83. That is monstrous from Kugler.
Yeah, fantastic result there. And right away, he's putting the gauntlet down and saying,
is
okay, guys,
ever.
I'm here to win it for the eighth time.
22.54. I was just about to start commentating and he finished. It was just done. It was finished.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen. Both cuts are good.
Both cuts are good. Nice announcement there from the referee. The crowd are loving this, by the way.
New season's best by Armin Kugler as well.
Wowee, that has put the cat amongst the pigeons, hasn't it? I mean, when you compare his time at 22.54, that is half of most of the other performers.
Yeah.
That is quite a statement.
Correct, and you can see here, both of these guys, their frequency of blows is pretty on point with one another, but it was Armin Kugler, you could see he's a good 4 or 5 strokes ahead as he moved to the other side of his block, and he was just super clean as he came through there.
What would be interesting to see would be whether Kugler can keep that kind of pace and form up as we go through the competition. Because, well, I mean, that is a heck of a statement right up, right off the bat.
And will it's he no be able secret to that height? He can do this. I mean, he's done it 7 times before. It's no secret that he can do it again. The question is, as always, is something maybe going to happen midway through this where it puts him off his game a little bit. So we'll keep a close eye on this as the day goes on. But we're going to check out, first of all, a side-by-side.
Let's take a look at the list of all of the athletes in that discipline. The underhand chop, as we can see, Kugler absolutely dominating with a time of 22.54, closely followed by Dallinger, 27.71. That was a personal best for him, so he will be absolutely delighted. And then 8 seconds off the lead was Hinterreiter, followed by Penker. Lier at the moment propping up the table. It's interesting to see that Dallinger and Kugler went up against each other in that last heat. Mm-hmm. I wonder whether that extraordinarily fast time of Dallinger was in some way driven forwards by sensing that I'm having to keep up with immense speed right next to me here on the stage.
Well, there's always that adrenaline push that you get from somebody else that's on the stage with you, so that's definitely a possibility, and we'll get to have a look at this with the head-to-head here on the side-by-side, and it just so happens to be that it was this last heat, and we'll get a really good view of it close and side-by-side. Let's take a look at that.
So here they are. You talked about, when we saw it live, about how the frequencies at the beginning started pretty similar, don't they?
Yeah, and you also saw that there was an easy start to the swing by Armin Kugler, but he was still on time for the opening hit. And then you could see he was quick to the other side. And if we count the number of strokes that he had on the other side before Dallinger moved over there, it was a good 4.5, 5 strokes. So, you know, he had the advantage right off the bat, and he knew it, and he was pretty confident about that whole thing. But what a great job by Gunther Dallinger to get over there and really have a good run against the top athlete here, or the top favored performer here.
I mean, Dallinger with his personal best, you can't do better than your personal best. I mean, he's got to be delighted.
Yeah, absolutely.
He's been at previous competitions. He's been there. He's done it. He's got some experience. But today, he's gone up against the best, and he's pretty much matched him.
Yeah, and you know what? Those personal bests are always great to see. We say that all the time, but it tells us that there are steps being taken every single time, which is awesome.
The next step for the athletes is the stock saw. Let's see what that is all about.
The STIHL MS-661 CM stock saw is used in STIHL timber sports as the ultimate test of operator's skill. Designed for the toughest jobs in forestry, it produces approximately 7.3 horsepower, has a displacement of 91.1 cc, and weighs 7.4 kilograms. To ensure evenly and fairly matched saws, professional STIHL technicians prepare and test the saws before each competition. Stock saw. After the starting shot, the contestants have to cut 2 wooden discs, so-called cookies, within a 10-centimeter mark, one downward and one upward. The attempt is only valid when both discs have been cut off completely and within the marks.
So, Discipline 2 of the Austrian Pro Championship 2022 is the stock saw. In Heat 1, we're going to see Penker up against Halmer. The second heat will be Hinterreiter versus Heiligenbrunner. Lier and Dallinger go at it in Heat 3 to be rounded off with Heat 4, Kugler versus Rich. The crowd loving this despite the, shall we say, on and off weather. Let's see whether Penker and Hammer are going to be on or off weather in Heat 1. Here they go up against each other, the first power tool discipline of this competition.
Now, you might say, oh, they've got motor saws or, you know,
chainsaws,
whatever you want to call them. You might say, oh, yeah, this is easy. Just put it on the wood and push. No, it doesn't work that way.
It does not work that way. You
have to have a feel there, and it's very much about the technique that you're using these saws with. And you're going to see different techniques as we go through the day. Okay. But if you push too hard or if you pull too hard to try and get a faster time, what's going to happen is you'll actually slow yourself down. So keep a close eye on how these guys activate the saw and the angle they have the saw in their body position and all the different things that they're doing to try and get the cleanest and quickest cut through that block.
Ready.
Stand to your timber.
This is heat one of the stock saw. This is Penker versus Haumer. Here we go.
Great start by Penker there. He got up quickly. Haumer was not that far behind him, and Pinker's got a nice transition to the upcut. Very interesting the way he leaned forward into that final upcut. And there's Haumer finishing off his cut. Good times for both of these guys. Penker with an 11.20, and that is a very good time.
11.20, he's going to love that, particularly the downstroke. Very smooth there, wasn't there?
But it was interesting to see his upstroke. Now, you see a lot of guys, they'll lean back and use their body weight and pull on the handle as they're
almost
leaning back.
Almost twist against
and,
it, right?
And the difference here was he was leaning forward and cutting towards the side of the log. That was the only guy I've ever seen use that particular style for cutting with the stock saw.
Hey, ladies and gentlemen, hope you got
the
cut.
Lovely reception from the local crowd here. They are giving the competitors so much support, which is great to see. So the time's been rounded up a little bit. In fact, it becomes a personal best for Penker, 11.09. Mm. And Manuel Haumer's time is also no disgrace at 13.44.
Yeah, let's take a look here. And that's Manuel Haumer right there on his down cut. You could see he got the body of the saw really close to the wood. Now here, I think that's Haumer again, that angle. Yep, that's Manuel. So he's got a nice first cut. Now watch the transition here. There's a big swing for him, and he moves quite far to the inside. Also a fairly decent swing, but watch Penker here, as he gets up on his almost off on his tippy toes and pushes forward with that saw. So that was a very interesting style.
Time for heat two. This is Hinterreiter going up against Harlingenbrunner. Two huge men here. Loads of power, but this is a discipline where you don't only need power. In fact, sometimes the power might even be a disadvantage.
It is.
This is about strategy. It's about control. This is about focus.
Hermann Heiligenbrunner is very good in this discipline. He is a solid sawyer. Families out there.
I was going to say, a lot of Austrian flags out there today. We saw all colours of flags yesterday at the World Trophy. Today, the majority, I would say, the vast majority are, of course, the beautiful colours of the Austrian flag, red and white. There's Hermann Heiligenbrunner, that last minute little personal internal pep talk, the focus, the tinted glasses to help him see as clearly as he can without any glare. All about focus here on this event.
Tapping the thymus in the middle of the chest there just to get that activity level in the body working a bit more. Make sure your focus is really on point.
Both hands must start on the log before this discipline can start.
Ready.
Stand to your timber.
This is heat two. This is Hinterreiter versus Heiligenbrunner.
Heiligenbrunner with a great start. Look at how clean and smooth both of these guys are. Wow, Heiligenbrunner, holy smokes, barely any touch as he transitioned beautifully.
Another two more quick ones.
Great time by Heiligenbrunner, 11.39. That puts him in third place at the overall right now. And second place in the stock saw results. And Heiligenbrunner looking good. Hinterreiter also a good time there with a 12.84.
All four Austrians so far today in the first two heats within 2.35 seconds of each other. So this is close.
Yeah, and we see that Bard Janssen walking down right away. Doesn't look like there's any problems with the cuts.
The boys were there right away, weren't they?
Yeah,
they were. Come on, Dad, we're ready to go. We just need the feedback. We know it was good.
Exactly.
Hinterreiter, there's the confirmation. 12.87, the final time given.
Now look at that first cookie there by Heiligenbrunner. That is paper thin. That is a beautiful initial cookie. And watch the transition here to the upcut. Very nice. A little bit of a downswing. And here with Hinterreiter. That's also a very nice transition to the upcut. The only thing there, he lost the tip of the saw a little bit into the wood, but not bad.
You
want to
keep that in your eye view, do you?
Yeah, you can't really because it's on the other side of the block, but you have to kind of guess with the length of the blade and everything.
Right.
So, but both of these guys had very, very nice, efficient cuts.
Time for heat three, and that is Gunther Dallinger, 34 years old, going up against the 2 years his senior, Joseph Lyer. Very dominant poses there in those images. Are they going to be as dominant on the stage?
Even times for both of these guys. So if we're talking about a head-to-head elimination round, this could well be one of the closest heats there is. But as we said right off the top of the show, this isn't about an elimination. It's about getting the best time and getting as many points as you can moving towards the next heats and the next disciplines and the next rounds. You can see all the different safety equipment these guys are required to wear there. Josef Lyer with the pants on and the ear protection and the eye protection. Here we go. Also, you'll see them warming up the saws. It's not a cold start for these guys. These saws stay running, and the rubber pads that are on the ground there, we talked about this a few times. It's a new thing that's come in the last few years to make sure that the saws don't walk away on them when they're waiting to start the heat.
You wouldn't want that, would you?
No. It's no fun to chase a saw across the boards here.
E3, the stock saw. Gunther Dallinger versus Joseph Lyer.
Gunther Dallinger with a great start. Actually, it was just a hair faster than Josef was.
Wow,
but Josef catching up
that,
to him pretty
he?
Well. And Josef's got a great upcut, but he's got a pretty thick block there. Gunther Dallinger with a 12:15. Josef Lyer with a 13:31. And that time for Gunther Dallinger.
Good enough for third place so far.
Yeah.
12:15. We'll have to wait and see if the judges nudge that score upwards or downwards in any way, but at the moment it's only 1.06 seconds off the lead, currently being held by Stefan Penka with a time of 11:09. That is good enough at the moment to take Dallinger into first place overall, but of course we've yet to see Rich and Kugler in the last heat of this event. There's the confirmation from the referee, Dallinger 12:06. Lyer's got to also be happy with only a fraction slower, 13:02.
Now here you see Josef, he starts the chain moving only when he's hovering over the block, whereas other athletes will start pulling the trigger and getting that chain running before they're even halfway up the block.
Is it possible it wasn't at full speed by the time he embraced the wood?
Nah, not likely. These saws are so efficient that the minute you pull the trigger, they're right there and working immediately. So that's not really the issue. It's just about
steel engineering, right?
Yeah, exactly. It's about every small advantage. And if you've got that chain running by the time you're ready, then you don't have to hover and wait for entry into the wood. You can just go straight at it.
Rich versus Kugler will be heat number four. The world record stands at an extraordinary 8.51 seconds. The Austrian national record stands at 10:60, and Armin is only a fraction off that with his personal best at 10:96.
Yeah.
So who knows? We could see fireworks in front of the Rathaus today.
It was funny to see that stock saw world record drop in at the Nordic Pro Championship last year. Ole Magnus Suljeberget got it, and he was like, hey, what? Huh? I've got the world record? And then in the interview afterwards, it was like, yeah, it was a bit of a surprise, but I'll take it.
Absolutely right. You saw Rich there with a crayon just making the last-minute markings on the woods. Those don't affect their scores or their performance in any way, but some athletes do like to do it to give themselves a guideline of where they want to strike with the blade.
I love that you called it a crayon.
It looks like the kind of crayons my kids write on the street on outside.
Yeah.
You know? Slightly more impressive technology involved, I can assure you. Right, this is
ready.
The fourth and final
Stand
heat.
To your timber.
It's the stock saw, and it's Rich versus Kugler.
So Peter Rich with a great start, actually a little bit faster than Kugler, but look how efficient Kugler is cutting there. Barely any bottom swing as he comes through the upcut, but it's going to be Rich. Oh, yes, a little bit faster than Kugler. He's got himself a personal best
at
12:04, and Kugler with a 12:61. Not his fastest cut, but he'll be satisfied with a good time there, and that should put him into, let's see, Armin. Oh, my goodness, fifth place for Armin Kugler in stock saw at the moment.
Thumbs up there from Rich. He absolutely loved that, and the crowd loved it as well. There's almost a feeling here in the arena, you know, Kugler's not going to have it all his own way.
Nope. And interesting note here, after two disciplines, Stefan Penker atop the leaderboard with Armin Kugler sitting in second place.
That is what we want to see. We want to see competition. A high five there from the person with the very beautiful blue umbrella. We start looking at the head referee here, Jörg, and then we go straight over to the movement. It was such a smooth downstroke, wasn't it, from Kugler?
Yeah, you and Andy had some fun conversations last night, hey?
We but that was a beautiful first right. cut.
And look at how thick that second cookie is. There was a big swing to the inside.
That's not helpful for the athlete.
Not helpful, but he got lucky here that he didn't go too far over, because you don't want to cut over that blue line. That's that 10 centimeter mark.
At the end. You can see at the top.
Yeah, the angle was just coming close. And I mean, you know, you could see Armin Kugler. He's such a pro, and he had a thicker second cookie as well, but managed to get a clean cut.
That magnanimous show of emotion from Kugler at the end there is justified. Only good enough for fifth place with his 12.41. That event was dominated by Penka with his personal best of 11.09. That gets him 12 points, or I beg your pardon, adds to his points of 12, making an overall score of 21. So Penka currently ahead of Kugler in the overall rankings. Dallinger in third place. Rich, Haumer and Leier at the bottom. We can see in a moment a comparison, Heiligenbrunner versus Penka, and those different types of techniques. You were talking about the angle of approach. Mm-hmm. We were at the Rookie Academy a couple of months back in Holland, right?
Yep.
And we had the pleasure of working with some great real teachers and mentors.
Yeah, Hans-Ove Hansen was up there, one of the best in the business when it comes to the stocks off, for instance.
Exactly, and I remember us watching that workshop where they were talking about the technique there of trying to get the nose behind the blade and really follow the machine with your body.
Correct.
Let's take a look at this clip and see how those boys do that, whether there's that accuracy. Here we go. They both start quite low down, and then it's all about, as I say, can you see those heads? On the left, you see Penka's head right on top of the blade. Heiligenbrunner a little bit further behind.
But here's what I was talking about earlier. Heiligenbrunner more upright, Penka leaning forwards into the saw as he makes that final cut, and it really did well for him. So those two were very solid cuts by both of those gentlemen.
Beautiful. That is a cracking start to the competition. We've had two disciplines. Penka currently leading the table, but there is a long way to go. You've seen the wood flying all over the place already. Let's check out where this wood comes from and the competitive level of the preparation involved.
STIHL Timbersports is an international extreme sports competition series featuring six disciplines, three chopping and three sawing. We have a premier competition, we need premier wood. The biggest challenges that I face as part of my role is to ensure that our competitions are supplied with the highest quality wood.
Each individual tree is examined for its conformation before processing. We need to make it fair for all athletes, so we are selecting different sections of the trees to use for each of our specific disciplines.
Once the trees are felled, extracted and transported to our facilities, we measure, mark and then cut the wood into sized blocks. We then peel the blocks ready for competition. After careful selection, the blocks then leave our yard and are distributed internationally to our STIHL Timbersports competitions.
So it is time for discipline three. That is the standing block chop. Let's see what this discipline has in store.
Standing block chop. At the standing block chop, the felling of a tree with an axe is simulated. A vertically positioned wooden block with a diameter of 27 centimeters has to be cut through from both sides. A powerful and precise swing with the axe is the premise of a good result.
So let's take a look at the starting list for the standing block chop. Four heats again. Penka, the current table leader, going up against Haumer in heat one. Hinterreiter against Rich in heat two. Heat three is Dallinger-Leier, and Heiligenbrunner against currently fifth place, but before the tournament started, favorite Armin Kugler. He was a great. We zoom out of that great from the building there to look at these potential new two greats, Stefan Penker, Manuel Heumer, in heat one. Will they get anywhere close to that world record of 11.03?
Well, Stefan Penker has been showing us a little bit of gumption today, you know, being on top of the leaderboard at the moment, if I don't misspeak here, with 21 points after two disciplines. Yeah, I mean, he's really putting a bid in to be the next national champion for Austria in steel timber sports. And if that is the case here today, that means we'll be seeing him at the individual world championships in Gothenburg.
So, standing block chop. They have to come from both sides, yeah. at least one stroke from each side.
Stand to your timber.
But which side they start from is their own choice. This is Penker Halmer in heat one.
So Penker gets started right away with good frequency on his drivers. Halmer going for those big power blows again. But Halmer, you have to give him a lot of credit. He's super accurate with those big power blows. So you're not seeing him get that axe stuck very often. And there you see just some big slabs coming off from the big man there as he adjusts his position, gets a little bit toward the front of the log. And now Halmer is the one that's moving to the other side. And Penker's already there, actually, is looking good to be through that quickly. Depends on the time here and who's going to have a fast time between these two as they pass the 35-second mark. Penker looking good as he's getting a couple of last drivers going through there.
Here goes, last blow.
One, two more. Oh, that's a rough situation when it's just hanging on by a thread. But Penker with a 39.85 personal best chop. Halmer getting close to the 50-second mark. And he drops it at 50.04. But I'm telling you, 50.04 is going to disappear down to 49 and change because that block definitely went down before the timer stopped.
And I think we just saw, in fact, that both scores were corrected down because the very first time was stopped a fraction early, I believe, because it felt like the top of the block was going to about to topple, but then didn't.
Yeah.
Let's just wait for the confirmation from the judges and those exact confirmed times. Like we say, the exact timing equipment here, there are fail-safe mechanisms to make sure that no competitor leaves the stage with an incorrect time. Let's see if both cuts are good, first of all.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, both cuts are good.
They certainly are. So double thumbs up. And there is the confirmation. Penker 42.40, which is a personal best. And you were right. You called it under 50 seconds for Halmer.
Yeah, 49.71 for Manuel Halmer. So that was, I mean, it just appeared to me as though that block dropped and the timer ran just a little bit longer, which is normal. It happens. And that's why they have these highly accurate pieces of equipment to make sure they get really good and proper timing here.
Look at the focus on his face there.
Yeah, absolutely.
Using gravity, using the swing. Sometimes the power is so much that it, in fact, works against the athlete because then the axe gets stuck. You don't want that, do you? You want to go in and out as quickly as you can.
That's true, and that also is a matter of the rhythm and the pace that you have. But Halmer, he did such a great job with his accuracy and his angle and everything. And right there, you see Penker. Oh, that is just those moments where you go, oh, no, and you got to go back with the axe and get there. But he did a great job to react to that.
Well, it'll be interesting to see whether, what is that, a second, maybe a second and a half? Doesn't feel like a lot. But it'd be interesting to see if that's decisive moving forwards, for example, in heat two.
It can be decisive.
Let's check it out. This is Hinterreiter going up against Rich in heat two. The current fastest time to beat is 42.40. That was that personal best from Penker that we just saw. That is also good enough to keep him at the top of the overall leaderboard at the moment. But of course, with three heats to go, getting the stance right. It's all about getting that balance and making sure that you can move that center of gravity across quick enough to generate enough power, right?
Also wanted to mention here, two absolutely opposite guys on stage when you're talking about, body styles. Rich is thin, tall, and Hinterreiter is powerful and tall. And you could see, you know, we'll be able to see here the difference in this, the different body types as well as how they work. And Peter Rich has got some power there. You can see him throwing those big drivers into the block. He got the axe stuck. Meanwhile, Hinterreiter, great style there as well for him as he moves over to the other side. About one and a half, two, three. No, has quite a few strokes ahead of Peter Rich. Peter Rich has gone for A bit of a crazy chop on the first side, and Hinterreiter looking very good to take this one down. It should be about three, four more drivers. No, excuse me. It's one more driver for Hinterreiter.
And 30.60.
And Peter Rich trying to get through that block, struggling. It should be a couple more for him there. It's wiggling and waggling on top. And he finally does it in 42.22 in a personal best. He'll be happy with a personal best. That's great. Little bit of a shoulder shrug from Peter Rich, though, as Andy Hall goes over and checks on their blocks to make sure that everything is on the up and up, gives a thumbs up to...
You see Hinterreiter leaving the stage there with two axes. We obviously didn't see them swinging two axes, nope. But they can take a second.
Can you imagine? Bang, 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 bang.
Oh, that should be a new event for next year. That would be amazing.
Make the axe handles shorter like and out of carbon fiber and just have them hitting from both sides.
Like a nunchuck event. I would be into that. Hinterreiter holds both of those axes aloft with one hand, and I'm telling you, they're not light, those things. He's got to be delighted. 30.39. is a cracking time, 12 seconds faster than the second fastest today.
I see here Peter Rich, he's got his accuracy, could use a little bit of help here as he's gone in a couple of different spots, slabbing out nicely though as he's gotten some big chunks and big chips going away from that block. And you can see using those long arms with some big drivers. You know, for a man that doesn't appear to be a monster, he's got some power behind his swing, and that's by virtue of a very strong core. But the only thing here for him is he's got to work on that accuracy a little bit so that he can get in as clean as possible with every blow. Now you can see here with Hinterreiter, he's got some nice powerful shots. His accuracy is pretty good, but he had a couple of straight shots into the middle of the block, which is really tough to make a good cut. It almost bounces the axe back at you, but there it is. That's the way the cookie crumbles. I jumped on that one a little bit too early today, I think.
No, it's never too early for a bad wood pun. This is Heat 3 of the Standing Block Chop, and this is Dallinger going up against Liar. 27.92, the personal best from Liar. So this could be interesting. He hasn't had the best of days so far, Joseph, but if he were to pull out something anywhere close to that PB, it could be very interesting.
Yeah, he's got to pick up the pace a little bit, but this is a strong discipline for Josef, so let's see if he can do well here in this one and get a little bit of that self-confidence back up as now they're coming onto stage, and he'll be on stand B or stand number two on stage right.
With a very flashy pink axe cover there. I like that.
I have a feeling his wife chose those for him.
He's showing his feminine side. We like that here at Timber Sports. This is heat number three. The current time to beat is 30.39. Anything in the low 40s will get him up high on the list here.
At the moment, Stefan Penker is leading in the overall standings with 32 points, 3 points ahead of Matthias Hinterreiter with 29. But we still have this heat and one more to go, so we'll have some changing on the overall standings shortly. But for the moment, Stefan Penker can look at being on the top of the podium.
Athletes ready.
Stand to your timber. 3, 2, 1.
Dallinger versus Liar, Heat 3, Standing Block Chop.
Look at the wide stance on both of these guys, pushing off of that back foot, trying to really drive through the hips.
Huge chunks coming out there from Dallinger.
Big slabs coming off for Dallinger as well. Josef Liar still working on his first side.
Dallinger's
and
already gone onto the other side.
Two strokes behind Dallinger as he moves over to the other side. Now Dallinger really, really close there as he's throwing some big drivers into that block. You can see the accuracy of Josef Liar there.
The wobble,
and
here he goes to Dallinger.
Dallinger with a personal best of 30.05. Josef Liar struggling to get through that block as he had a little bit of a twist there, and it should come off now, and there it is at 40.14. And you know he's going to be very disappointed as he examines that block closely.
Wow, great performance there from Dallinger.
Fastest time so far today and a personal best.
It is. It's that personal best. We're going to have to see if that's adjusted down. Currently stands at 30.05, the fastest time today. And no slouch Josef Liar at all. He's got to be happy with that. He started the competition relatively slowly, finished last in the first event, but currently third in the standing block chart with a time of 39.6. four. So that big smile on that mustachio face is absolutely justified. There's the confirmation, 29-62 for Dallinger. And Joseph Lyer, 39-64. 10 seconds back, but good enough for third place at the moment. He's guaranteed fifth place, of course, at least in this discipline.
Big slabs there in the slow-mo you can see from Joseph Lyer.
That is a water drop on the camera. That is not a piece of wood flying towards the camera person. And you can already see the block wobbling on the left-hand side for Dallinger, couldn't you?
Yeah,
it was just a matter of time.
It was just being held on by threads, more or less, and he did a great job to get that final cut and that driver through. And you can see here, look at the push off of that back leg, the use of the core to really power that axe through the block, and
the
that
next
was a beautiful
person,
finishing cut from
the
Joseph.
Next person that tells me that these boys aren't athletes, really, I cannot hear that. Look at the power and the strength that goes into that. Remarkable stuff. Talking about power and strength, two absolute power hitters coming up. Heiligenbrunner going up against the master, Armin Kugler. There could be fireworks here. 19.92 is Armin Kugler's personal best. If there was anything close to that here, that would be 10 seconds under anything we've seen here. So
Armin Kugler needs to win this one to move to the top of the leaderboard at this point. But unfortunately, because of his times previous, he'll still sit in second place. But then he'll have 32 points. At the moment, he's at 20. So let's see if he can do that. And he's well practiced at this discipline. It's just a matter of putting that practice into play.
Dallinger and Penke currently with 11, 9, and 12 points, and 9, 12, and 9, respectively, in the first three rounds. Really setting a challenge here to Kugler, which
very
is exactly
so.
What we want to see.
Yeah.
We want to see a high level of competition in the Austrian field. Heiligenbrunner going up against Kugler in the fourth heat of the standing block chart.
Now, Armin Kugler, he's really moving that axe quickly. He's got a great pace, and he's moved over to the other side already. So this is looking good for Armin right off the bat. He's very strong in this discipline, and he is not messing around today. He knows he needs the points, and it looks like he might be close to getting the fastest time, and he's going to do it. 23.55 for Armin Kugler, and that puts him with a 12-point score in the standing block chop at the top of the leaderboard. Heiligenbrunner with a 34.25 comes in third place overall, and Heiligenbrunner with a fourth place in standing block chop. But Armin Kugler is a good 6 seconds faster than Gunther Dallinger for the top spot in standing block.
23.25 seconds for Kugler. We have been upping him all day, and I think that is justified. He had a little bit of a dip in the last discipline in the stock saw, didn't bring his full power there, but right back on. Takes first place in the underhand chop, takes first place in the standing block chop. Good enough for 32 points as it stands.
But that's just 1 point ahead of Gunther Dallinger at the moment in the overall standings. So let's take a look back here.
Starting from the bottom, coming from down to up from Heiligenbrunner, and then going from up to down. Two strokes each.
Yeah, the rules say that you have to start with your first cut as an up cut or from the bottom, and then you can go from there and alternate up and down. So many athletes will opt for two hits at the bottom and then two hits at the top, and then
sometimes
alternate back and forth.
Sometimes you see one and one, though, don't you?
Sometimes you do see one and one. It just depends on the athlete, but you always have to start from the bottom. And this is also a discipline that requires quite a lot of control in the axe, because the wrong angle can also cause the axe to skip and fly away from the block. So you really have to be adept with the axe in hand. And I mean, we saw it here with Armin Kugler. Just so fantastic with that block, sir.
Almost dismissively knocking that.
Yeah.
That frustrating and annoying, disturbing piece of wood out of his way. Out of my way. I'm Armin Kugler, and I'm coming through. 23.25, a fantastic time there in the standing block chop. Again, 12 points. That'll put him in good stead on the leaderboard. Lyer, Penke, Rich, and Halmer currently struggling in fifth to eighth place, respectively. And here we can say Dallinger and Heiligenbrunner not giving up the chase, currently only 1 and 4 points behind, respectively.
Yeah, and actually the results from the standing block chop are also the results in the overall standings for the moment in the first two positions at the very least. So, you know, a good run by Armin Kugler to get himself from a lower position in the standings and back up into the top spot. We've seen this many times from him before, but there's a couple of guys that are going to want to challenge him in the next disciplines.
Let's take a look. Mano a mano, split screen, so to speak, so we can compare techniques.
Yes, let's do.
Both starting with those upstrokes, as you said. Kugler on the right-hand side. So much speed and power there. He's in and he's right out again, isn't he?
Yeah, and Günther Dallinger is really, I mean, I didn't really pay attention to this, but now that I compare it to Armin Kugler side by side, you can see Günther Dallinger has a very quick pace on his axe as well. So a great job by both of these guys to adapt that new style of axe and just putting the power down and really going for it. And there's the last couple of drivers for Günther Dallinger. And this is where that block just sort of fell down and went flat plop on the board.
Beautiful performance from both athletes there. I've got two more beautiful athletes waiting down in the interview area. Florti is there with Hermann Heiligenbrunner. Florti, how's it going down there, and how is Hermann satisfied with his performance so far?
Well, Hermann Heiligenbrunner, as you would say, is very pleased indeed. We're having a good time here. He's in third position at the moment. Du bist im Moment Dritter in der Gesamtplatzierung. Da kann man, glaube ich, für den Moment zufrieden sein.
Ja, ups, also bin sehr zufrieden. Ist jetzt bis jetzt ganz gut gegangen, bin glücklich mit dem Holz, habe gute Blöcke erwischt und ja, ist immer eine sehr gute Position.
Du bist ja auch einer, der schon relativ lang dabei ist. Wie viele Jahre sind es genau?
Ja, bei mir ist jetzt das 22. Jahr. Ich habe mit 19 Jahren angefangen. Also. Und ja, bin eigentlich einer der vorrangigsten Sportler in Europa. Und ich habe gesagt, solange es Spaß macht, bleibe ich dabei. Und so wie es momentan ausschaut, ist es nur das eine oder andere Jahr.
Und macht Spaß hier am Rathausplatz? Wie gefällt es dir?
Ja, es ist eigentlich gigantisch. Wir sind seit Freitag da. Wir haben jetzt die Rookie-Trophy und die Damenbewerbung angeschaut und die World-Trophy gestern. Mega Stimmung da. Es ist händis wieder nicht ganz optimal, aber das Publikum, das gibt eigentlich richtig Gas. Also wenn man auf der Bühne rummert, Leistung anliefert, dann ist das Publikum da.
Du bist ja ein sehr erfahrener Athlet, wie du bereits gesagt hast. Wenn du das vergleichst mit anderen Veranstaltungen, wo würdest du es platzieren?
Ja, definitiv. Also, es ist unter Anführungszeichen nur österreichische Meisterschaft, aber das ist schon unter die Top 3 zu finden. Ja. Also, wenn es eine WM wäre, wäre es Platz 1 da in Wien.
So gefällt uns das. Großes Lob an euch und back to you guys. Hermann is going for big.
Thank you, you two big boys. We absolutely love that. My Fantastic. Apologies, Hermann, if I don't quite pronounce your name perfectly. You certainly have a beautiful Austrian drawl. We are loving it here in the Rathausplatz in beautiful Vienna, Austria. We had the World Trophy yesterday. We had the International Women's Cup before that. We had the Rookies Tournaments today, the Austrian Championships. But there
Busy
is
weekend.
Loads more to come in the season, including the big one, the World Championships in Gothenburg. We'll be there. Will you? Let's check it out. Get your ticket now. That's
very
important. Let's check it out. How does it look then?
The 2 meter long cross cut saw used for the single buck discipline is made especially for competition. A series of consistently patterned 10 centimeter long teeth are cut with a laser on one side of the saw and then hand sharpened. Saw teeth are divided into two types, cutters and rakers, just like on the old school saws. The saw weighs about 5 kilos and its base price starts at around 1,500 euros. Single buck. The single buck is a one-man saw about 2 meters long. With this, the athletes have to cut off a complete disc from a 40 centimeter thick wooden block. The perfect interplay between rhythm and strength is the key to success.
The single bark. This is where it's all at, the power, the precision. Heat one will be Haumer versus Leier. Heat two, Pitch going up against Hinterreiter. Heiligenbrunner, that we just heard in the interview, will be going up against Penker in heat three. And Dallinger will take on Kugler in heat four. This is one of those events, I think it's fair to say, dear CoComs, that is much harder than it looks.
Yes, I can tell you that from personal experience that I wasn't able to actually move the saw, but the key here is to get it moving and keep it moving with rhythm and flow and make sure that you don't overcompensate the angle of the saw, because if you do start to overcompensate the angle of the saw, then you're going to have a problem with it hooking up on the push through or the drawback, and then it's just a bear to try and restart that thing and get it moving again. So the best case scenario is a quick start and smooth, flowy draw and push through that block all the way.
What was that lyric from the 90s? Rhythm is a dancer.
Rhythm is a dancer. In this case, it's a rhythm is a Sawyer.
Rhythm is a Sawyer.
Here we go.
That could be the next big thing, couldn't it? Who will be the next big thing in the stock saw? Will it be Haumer or will it be Leier? Heat number one.
Well, you can see Joseph Leier really getting for those big, long strokes. The flow is fantastic for him. Haumer, though, doing exactly the same thing. Boy, this is going to be a close one. Look at how even they are. They're even, Steven, to the bottom of that line. It looks like it's going to be Joseph Leier getting this one. Oh, no! Haumer gets a twist out, breaks it off, but he stayed in position and got that last little lip cut off, so it should be a fair cut for him. The judges will definitely look at that, but you can see he's not happy about that at all.
Well, despite that little infraction, they're both good enough for personal best if those times stand. That is a big if, of course. We don't have any flags on the play as yet. I'm just checking on the stage. It doesn't look like there are any flags.
I don't think we got a problem because Haumer did keep his saw in play and cut off that last little tab at the bottom, and I think that they'll allow that.
Yeah, we can see the referee here, Bart Janssen, as he strides down to the circular stage area at the front. He's got a nice big smile on his face. I think he's got good news for both the athletes.
Either that or he's sadistic and wants to break somebody's heart.
Both cuts are good.
Yeah, there you go. Both cuts are good.
It turns out that our referees are not sadistic. Of course they're not. Two personal bests in heat one. And I tell you what, Lyre's coming from behind, isn't he? Yeah. He had a slow start, but another personal best there, 16.90.
Those are quite nice times. Under 20 seconds is good.
Very nice. The moustache is not the only thing that is flowing today. Good performance from Joseph. Great shot there from our director and the camera team. Beautiful. You can get a real feel for the amount of energy and dedication that is put into this sport.
He is going right to the knuckles on his cuts and drawing that saw all the way back through so the tip disappears in the wood. Look at how close he gets with his hands to the block. That is an efficient stroke right there.
What a shot that is.
Using the entire length of the saw. You know, you can be slow with the saw, but if you've got an efficient stroke, efficient is fast.
Efficient is fast. Just to give you, dear viewers, if you're not complete experts to this sport and thinking, that's a big saw, the log's not that big, that looks doable, 16 seconds, sounds about right. I was watching a corporate group this morning as they were setting up the stage. They had like a team day out, and these professionals who aren't sports people had the opportunity to have a go with the stock saw. I didn't see one of them go under 2 minutes. So this is a top-level athleticism that you're seeing.
That single buck is really difficult, and that's a good place to start in the world of timber sports, because you know it's not a dangerous tool, but it's a tool that will give you that first feel and that first touch of the wood as we get ready for our next heat here.
Oh yeah, you feel like an arborist, don't you, when you got that beauty in your hands?
Mm-hmm.
Right, this is heat number two. This is Rich going up against Hinterreiter. Just last minute preparations there. They're trying to get the teeth in exactly the right starting point so that the first angle of their cut is exactly as they've been practicing back home.
And the way that the saw is shaped as well, it's got a bit of a rocker through the teeth line at the bottom. So they want to try and place the saw so that they have the rocker just ahead of the top curve of the log, as you can see here.
Nice point. Rich versus Hinterreiter, heat two, single buck without assistance.
Rich right into it there. Really powerful
yeah,
stroke.
Very good job. Ooh, a bit of a hookup though by him as he has to stop and restart. Hinterreiter looking very good though, using the entire length of the saw to cut through. It's hopping a little bit, so it's looking like it's cutting his time down a little bit as he gets towards the bottom. And there it is with Peter Rich
another
getting through to 21.53 and a
personal best.
And a personal best for Hinterreiter. Fantastic.
It's personal best day here in the Rathaus in Vienna. Thumbs up to the camera from Hinterreiter, from Rich, sorry. He enjoyed that hugely, and so did we. Okay, I felt maybe it was the weather, maybe it was just that the athletes were a little bit cool. The first couple of disciplines, we didn't see extraordinary times, but personal best across the board so far in this discipline.
I was looking at Matthias there, Matthias Hinterreiter. He shook his head and seemed like he was a little bit disappointed with the cut, and even though he got a personal best, I think I know what the problem was, and if we look at the slow-mo a little bit later on, you'll see on his drawback that the saw was almost hopping through the drawback cut, so the teeth were snagging as they were coming through, so hopefully we'll get a picture of that later on. We can have a little bit of a closer look there, but great for both of them to have personal bests, and you know that Matthias is going to be focusing on trying to get really clean cuts. Now let's take a look here. This is Peter Rich right there. That's his saw. Nice, clean strokes. Hopefully we... Oh, there's that hookup that we saw that stopped, and he had to restart that saw. And as I mentioned, now here we go. Looking at Matthias Hinterreiter. Watch on the drawback. All right, right here it's not bad. It's when he gets down closer to the middle of the cut that the drawback seemed like it was hopping a little bit, which means that he was getting those teeth cut on the ridge of the outside edge of the cut on the far side of the log. Maybe we'll see it here a little bit closer. No, unfortunately not there either, but it was a great job by Peter Rich to get a nice final driver cut through there on that last stroke. And
you
he was
felt
pleased
like on that last
that.
Stroke, if that hadn't been the last stroke, he wouldn't struggle to get back up,
yeah,
wouldn't he?
Yeah, absolutely, because he was so deep. Yeah, he was so deep.
Heat 3 is going to be the part-time leader here. Penker going up against Hermann Heiligenbrunner. Every time in the single buck today has been a personal best.
Yeah,
these
fantastic.
Austrian pros are really warming up. This is exciting stuff. And I've got to give a shout out to the wonderful Vienna crowd here. Another great show today. Great numbers. We had enormous numbers yesterday and the day before as well, despite the slightly sort of come and go weather that we've got here.
Yeah,
they are loving every minute of it.
Bit of drizzle falling now. It's not as warm as it was yesterday. The last couple of days we've had really comfortable temperatures, albeit on Friday it was hot as an oven, but yesterday it was beautiful with a little bit of wind. Today the temperatures dropped a little bit, so you know, kudos to the people that have come out and are braving the rain and a little bit of a cooler day here on Sunday for this Austrian National Championship.
So the athletes just making the last minute preparations here.
And you'll see there Andy Hall next to Hermann Heiligenbrunner with a small measurement device, and he'll be guiding Hermann into the saw positioning, checking to make sure that the depth is just correct. Now Hermann will lift the saw out, and in this case you'll see Hermann, he puts it in upside down, so he's not in a cutting. He's not cutting, but he can do a couple of practice strokes to make sure that he's got the exact feel that he wants to have in that saw. And then he'll turn it over and replace it, which is what he's doing right now, and get ready to go.
These saws are razor sharp, but the prongs there are so long that if you get stuck, sometimes you worry that you're never going
to
get out. The focus, the concentration, the eyes of the performers. This is Penker and Heiligenbrunner in heat 3 of the single buck, and they're off.
Wow, great start by Heiligenbrunner as he gets that saw moving straight away with long, solid fusion strokes there. Penker now joining him on those longer ones. He had a couple of shorter strokes to get started, but it's going to be Heiligenbrunner on this one with a bullet, 17.54. And that is a personal best for Heiligenbrunner and for Penker with a 22.16.
Stop it with the personal best
awesome.
Today. This
it's a
is
great day.
Silly.
We got some good wood on deck today.
That is 6 single buck personal bests. Just think about this. Just take it this way, Troy, if you would. Yesterday, all of these 6 were slower in the single buck than they are today.
Yeah.
What do you think of that? All six of them.
These guys had some good times today, and their training through the weekend has made small adjustments coming into today.
They chose the right breakfast cereal this morning,
they
clearly.
Did. Yeah, their muesli was full of good nutrients and power food. One
Joseph
more heat to go.
Lyer, still the fastest in the single back as we speak, with one heat to go with a time of 16.90. Like we say, he started very slowly.
Okay,
unfortunately,
gentlemen.
He was last after the first discipline. But his recent upturn has been good enough for third place. Stefan Penker is currently second on the leaderboard with 36 points. And Hanningenbrunner comfortably in the lead at the moment by 6 points with 42 points, but all still to play for, with Dallinger and Armin Kugler still to come in the single back.
Here you can see Pinker with a couple of short strokes to start that saw off, and then he gets into the rhythm with those nice long strokes. Meanwhile, Heiligenbrunner in the background went for the full-on, full-length strokes right off the bat, and you can see he's really just using all of his power to get that saw going and keep it moving, and he did such a great job, and by virtue of that, he's got a stupendous time of 17.27. just about 0.37 seconds behind Josef Lyer, 16.90. So great job by Heiligenbrunner there to keep himself in the running. At the moment, as you mentioned, Matt, he's in top spot. Josef Lyer sitting in third place. So the worst case scenario for Josef at this point is he'll drop down to fifth place if both of these guys have spectacular times.
This is heat four, Dallinger versus Kugler. It is really heating up. It felt at the beginning of the tournament today that maybe a couple were going to run away with this, but all of the athletes putting in their absolute best and flattening the field here. This is what we like to see. Increasing competition, right?
Yeah, fantastic. There's Armin Kugler there. Now, this is the single buck without assistance, so sometimes you'll see them on stage single buck with assistance, where they have somebody spraying the blade and putting a wedge in to make sure that that block that they're cutting off...
We saw that yesterday in the rookies,
correct,
example, didn't we?
So that block doesn't bind on the saw. But the advantage here for these guys today, with a little bit of rain falling, there is already a lube on that saw with
you
the rain.
You can see it, in fact, there on the stock saw, can't you?
Yeah, it's correct. So that gives them a little bit of an advantage in that sense, that they don't have to worry about somebody spraying the saw while they're running through that block. You can also see the shoes there from Gunther Dallinger, and I believe that, Armin Kugler also has spiked shoes on, but we've got a problem here. So there's a bit of a stoppage.
I think, in fact, the referees might be calling it because of the weather. No, it turns out that I've been told that the block of wood that was set to be Kugler's block is a little bit loose. So those bolts that you see there going through that metal sheath that holds the blocks, they are powered through with powered screwdrivers, and they are huge screws as well.
Yeah, they use an impact screwdriver. That's the only way to get those screws into the block to make sure that it stays secure. And it's a good thing that they caught that, because that would be a really unfair situation for Armin Kugler, quite frankly, if that block is moving while you're also trying to saw. It's going to make it a terrible experience, and the only thing that's going to happen there is the times are going to be slow, because you're adjusting the whole time with the way the saw is moving, with the way the block is moving.
Well, exactly. I mean, in the worst case scenario, you can even have a health and safety issue. So it's a great job that the referees have spotted this early. You see the referees checking as the athletes are approaching their saws. The referees are there as well on the spot. And we can see that that Armin and his team, that Bart and his team have spotted here a slight incorrection. And look at this. I mean, this is just, it's a great opportunity for us to give another shout out to the incredible STIHL Timbersports team here. Look at this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's like a Formula One pit crew, isn't it?
Yeah.
Just getting the equipment set here.
Either
wonderful
that or a
job
union job. No, but what I also wanted to add a little bit of thing here is that the drawback for the athletes in this case is, okay, they're getting a fair competition block. They're making sure that everything is correct for this competition, but the poor guys that have to actually compete are standing around now cooling down. So that's an issue.
It's a good point. It's a good point. Yeah, it is a good point. We can see Dallinger standing there, stage right at the moment. He's got his bright orange shoes on. You won't miss him. But as you say, the longer he has to stand there without going through the exercise that he thought he was going to be going through, the muscles may be cooling just a little bit.
Yeah.
So we'll have to wait and see how long it takes for the team to sort this out. Maybe while we are waiting, another reminder of the events coming up.
Yeah.
You know, we've had a wonderful weekend here. We've had four tournaments spread over 3 days, which has just been fantastic. Five, in total.
And it's going to be a busy season in general. There's lot of other events coming up. There's the British Nationals. There's the French Nationals. There's the Polish Nationals. We've got the Benelux competition coming up as well. And then at the very end of the season, the World Championships in Gothenburg. So
Gothenburg, Sweden. They love their timber sports up there as
they
well,
do,
don't they?
Indeed.
It's going to be in a beautiful arena. We are reliably informed. There's going to be a great atmosphere there. Tickets are available for the team event. Tickets are also available for the individual event. And
correct.
Some of those superstars that we saw yesterday bashing the heebie-jeebies out of the wood, they're going to be in Stockholm as well, aren't
yes.
they?
We're going to see a lot of these guys up there as well. And it appears as though our block
is
ready.
It looks like they are ready on the stage. We're getting one last inquisitive look from Kugler. He seems happy with it, and he's been there and done it. So if he's ready to go, then I think we're ready to go. Well done, all of the team there. Thank you for getting that sorted so quickly. The saw goes back into his place, and we are just about ready for heat four. And that's Günter Dallinger going up against Armin Kugler. Dallinger currently down in seventh place overall. This could take him up a couple of places. Kugler out as well. 31 and 32 points respectively. So
okay.
If one of them were to get the best time
ready.
Overall, it would even propel them
send
right to the top of the leaderboard. Heat four, Dallinger, Kugler.
3, 2, 1, go!
Wide stance for both of these guys, and both of them starting off right away with long, strong strokes. Armin Kugler, very adept at this discipline, but Günter Dallinger, also no slouch, as he is looking very good, keeping up to Armin Kugler. Armin Kugler picking up the pace, though, as he gets to the bottom of that block.
Listen,
with a really good time.
Oh,
16.29 and a 17.83 for Günter Dallinger, and a personal best, probably propelled a little bit along by the fact that he knows that he has a seven-time Austrian champion in his back pocket there, trying to get a good time. So great job by both of these guys.
If you want to get anywhere close to Kugler, you've got to put in a PB, and all six of the other competitors have delivered a PB here, but it still wasn't good enough to top Armin Kugler in the single butt with that absolutely ridiculous time of 15.93 in the single buck.
Okay,
lovely reception again from the crowd, giving the athletes here some great support in the drizzly weather. Dallinger, there's the confirmation. Good enough for second place for 17.6 seconds, but that absolutely lightning 15.93 from Kugler. He is an extraordinary athlete, isn't he?
Yeah, it's amazing, because to look at him walking down the street, you wouldn't think that he is as flexible and as powerful as he is, but he is right on point when it comes to this stuff. He is so good. And look at that. He, too, going right to the knuckles almost with that saw. Absolutely one of the most efficient sawyers when it comes to the single buck here. And look at the stance, really stepping off of that back foot, using that core power, pushing those arms through, keeping the flow going. It is a dance with that saw, and he is a virtuoso.
Wow, what a discipline. Six personal bests and a sub-16 second single buck. They are really bringing it here in front of the Rathaus in Vienna. And that means that the current standings are Kugler currently in first place with 48 points, followed by Günter Dallinger in second place with 41. Hermann Heiligenbrunner, 40 points as a result of the single buck standings that we see here.
Look at all those
Kugler coming
bests.
Up on top.
Amazing.
And look at that. PB, 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 PB. We love to see that. All within 7.26 seconds of each other. The field is close. The field is tight. And the overall standings are as follows. Kugler leading the table, as we see, followed by Dallinger and Heiligenbrunner, and Rich and Haumer currently with 29 and 24 points, propping up the field. The times seem to be getting faster, don't they?
They do. You know, but we saw this in here, and there's a lot of pressure on these guys to perform in front of their home audience, obviously. And of course, being up against other Austrians in this case, it really helps propel them. And we saw that, a little bit of that adrenaline push for a few of these guys in particular for the last heat there. We saw both of them going at it. And
let's take a look at that, shall we?
With a very, very excellent heat. And we're going to see that side by side here so we can really get a direct analysis for these two guys. There's Josef Lyer, excuse me.
So
he
we've
was,
got Lyer on the
fastest,
right here.
Yeah.
And we've got I mean on the left.
And you can see both of them were using the same stand and both of them going knuckles to tip for their cuts. And wow, look how close they were. It was just 1.5 strokes difference between Kugler and Lyer. That was a nice pairing.
I mean, only 0.97 seconds between them. Yeah. So, I mean, it's we're not talking large amounts of time at all
Minuscule.
Joseph Lyer again. I think he's going to be very interesting going towards the latter stages of this competition.
So,
he started slowly, didn't he? But he's catching up.
He is catching up.
You know what else catches up? It's fast cars and powerful cars. We are delighted to be supported by Ford Ranger. Let's check out our sponsors. Here we go. There it is, the Ford Ranger, an absolute powerhouse. Please support our sponsors because they support us. All of the events that we put on just would not be possible without the support of our amazing sponsors.
That is not just a Ford Ranger. That is a Ford Raptor. That is a wicked vehicle. I wouldn't mind having one of those. Hint, hint, hint.
Yeah, I'm getting a clear signal from the director that there's no chance.
Yeah.
I tell you what, there is a chance of there. Getting a little bit of a flashback. When I'm told that it's a new fad sport, this timber sports, you know what? Mm-mm. It's not. It's been around for quite a while. Check this out.
Expert woodsman who can cut down a tree more easily than most people can chop one up. When it really comes to tackling large lumps, you can't beat the men of the forestry companies.
An axeman's gathering.
As Tom is losing the loss, he gets it!
Check it out on YouTube. There's so much history in this sport. It's such an amazing buzz.
It's really funny because people don't realize how long that's been, from a $50 bet all the way to where we're at now with some of the best athletes in the world competing here on the stage today. So, yeah, I mean, there's a lot of pedigree in the sport and there's a lot of pedigree here with us today.
You know what there also is next to that pedigree is just pure passion.
Yes.
I mean, I was honored enough to be able to witness that firsthand yesterday. We're just a few feet away from the stage here. Today, the Austrian Championships as well, of course, but yesterday, the World Trophy, absolute packed house.
Yeah.
I mean, it was just goosebumps moment, wasn't it? If you haven't, and this is a genuine plea to anyone out there who hasn't yet had the opportunity to see a timber sports event, if you do, if there's one popping up in your town coming up in Birmingham, England, for example, coming up, or the Paris Open, or for example in Gothenburg, go and check it out because it is pure passion.
Live is life.
It
comes down to Mitch Argent and Shane Gordon.
Battling hard on the standing block. Who is it going to be? Is it going to be Australia or New Zealand? Oh my God, how close is this? And it's Australia!
The atmosphere last night in the team's relay was unreal.
That is their title, a team world champion.
Oh, definitely. It'd be the noisiest crowd I've competed against.
Shane Jordan's already over there.
Yeah, I'm actually kind of getting goosebumps thinking about it right now.
The crowds here, they were just erupting.
You feel the energy of the crowd.
My goodness, what a great comeback from Belgium!
The crowd was absolutely electric.
And it was so much noise and support.
Ja, doch, das Pushstone Row und mein Fanclub ist auch da.
Very passionate about their country and, yeah, the competitors. Yeah, it feels super.
Oh my goodness, look at this!
Pretty awesome to compete in front of a crowd like this.
But he's not giving up. He's looking good.
Like such an adrenaline rush. It's an amazing feeling.
They make a lot of noise, and that's good for our spirit.
Is it going to be the Czech Republic? And the crowd goes bananas.
It's absolutely extreme here. Man hört.
STIHL TIMBERSPORTS, the original extreme sport. If you haven't got a chance so far, you have got to get yourself a ticket for the next event at the very latest, Gothenburg in October, for the team and individual world championships. We are here at the Austrian Championships in Vienna, Austria. We are through to the fourth discipline, and that is the springboard. This is one of my favorites. Have a look at this.
Springboard simulates the traditional way of felling trees by climbing up over thick branches. First, a notch, known as a pocket, is chopped into the log. The springboard is then anchored into this pocket. Now the athlete will climb up onto the springboard to chop a 27-centimeter wooden block from both sides at the top of the log.
And here we are. The springboard heats will be Hammer against Leier in heat one. It'll be Rich going up against Hinterreiter in heat two. Heat three will be Penker versus Hanningenbrunner. And the current table leader, Kugler versus Dallinger, will be heat four. So talk us through the springboard. This is beautiful, isn't it?
Well, the springboard is a very finicky discipline, and the rookies have just started playing with the springboard with a single board, while here with the pros, we're going to see the springboard with two boards. So these guys are going to be about 2 meters off the ground with a razor-sharp implement in their hands, trying to cut off a block off the top from both sides, as we saw in the description. The thing about it here is the speed of getting your pocket set.
The pocket being that first sort of hole or gash that you've cut into the log to try and get the springboard in there, right?
So, yeah, it's where you place your board.
Sorry to interrupt. You get a feel of the height of those beams, don't you?
I mean, that's our air or our fly camera going over top, and it feels like you could touch the top of the block if you were hanging from the fly camera. That's how close it is. So that's very, very high up there. Now, as I was mentioning with the pockets, the perfect pocket is about a four-hit pocket. Then you place the board, get on that first board, set the next pocket, put the other board in and get up top, and then you can start working on that top block.
And then it's about the angle of where you put those blocks, right? What you don't want to be doing is, for example, putting them on top of each other, the pockets, because then you're not going to be able to clamber on.
That's
and
correct.
And also, you were telling me yesterday, it's also about that angle of approach once you're up there. You don't want to be having to do sort of, I don't know, reverse underhand or overhand swings. You want to be getting as much power as possible.
Well, the thing about getting the power off of these boards is to make sure that your board has enough of an angle so that when you do step on that it doesn't go below flat. So ideally...
That's the sagging that they were talking about yesterday.
That's correct. If the board is flat, then you can step off of that back foot just like they do with the standing block chop and put the power through the back leg, through their core, into the block. If the board is sagging, the athlete will tend to step forward on the board and then choke up on the axe so that he's not getting as much power into the top block, and that's a big problem. So keep a close eye on some of the boards and how they place the boards. That's going to be a key thing, but it's also about making sure those boards are placed quickly and efficiently so that you can get up top. And what I should mention is that the world record time held in springboard with two boards is held by Sterling Hart from Canada. Good Canadian kid! From the individual world championship in 2016, get this, 35.67 seconds. That is an incredibly fast time. Now, the difference with his time is that when he got up on top, he switched his body position and made sure that he's got an ambidextrous swing, so he had that advantage.
Ooh,
and
that would be nice.
We're going to show you the difference here when these guys get up on top of the board as well, how they've got that awkward backhand swing. So our first setup is looking to be correctly done and ready to go.
Another great job by the team there. Thank you for setting all of that up. We're going to see how versus Lyre. We're going to see whether Troy's description there of that wonderful sort of backhand technique, whether that will be applied by the Austrians here today. It will be very interesting to see. They're just putting those springboards there. They are not springy, I can tell you, dear viewer. They are quite stable. And I think if I can kind of summarize your description of the sport that you just gave me, sagging is bad and pocket is good, right?
A good pocket with a flat board is good. Sagging board is no good. But sometimes it's a second guessing yourself where you're setting the pockets, and you can, I mean, like I said, an ideal pocket is four hits, boards in, it's stable, and you can go up to the next pocket and move on. But sometimes these guys will second guess themselves. They'll look at their pocket and think, maybe it's not right. They'll clean it out. They'll take a couple more hits at it, and that's what really kills the time.
Sagging is bad. You heard it here first. Okay, there is the all-decisive whistle.
We are
ready for heat one of the springboard.
Okay.
It's Manuel Halmer versus Josef Lyre.
Stand to your timber. 3, 2, 1, go!
All right, Josef Lyre right away with a couple of nice hits there. I didn't get a chance to count cleanly because the angle of the camera changed, but... Halma, he's got, I think that's about a 6-7 hit pocket. Now here's the first board placement by him. Check when he gets up. Now here's the advantage for a guy like Josef Lyre, who is not exactly a light guy, but compared to Halma, he is. And so Halma's got himself a good solid board. I don't see any sag in the board. Josef Lyre now trying to set that second pocket and make sure that he's got himself a good position to get up on top. And you can see the board sagging for Halmer already there. Yeah, I didn't see that he had it. So he's second-guessing himself on the pocket, and now he's resetting that pocket. And this is the time killer. This is the problem.
That is going to do it for him, isn't it?
Yeah, that's going to be a problem when Josef Lyre's got his second board in position, and he's already working on that top block. Now, whoa, there's a big skip by the axe as the angle just wasn't quite on.
But Lyre's he's got up a for great, the second, though, already.
Yeah, he's got a great flat board there. He can use his back foot out far on the deck of that board and really put the power into the block, and it's looking very good for him up top there. And he's going to go deep on the first side. They have to cut through from both sides, and Josef looking very good on the top as they've just passed the 115 mark here, and now he'll switch to the other side. He just does a quick switch around there, and here's the difference. Josef takes that ambidextrous approach. He changed his body position and the axe position, so he's not swinging with an awkward backhand swing. He's actually got a very good solid swing here, but he's got to get through there in under the 2 minutes, otherwise it's going to be a DQ for timeout. But he's looking good. He's getting close to finishing off
that
block.
Here it comes, here it comes. I think we're going to see a topple. Yeah, just a couple more.
He can see it as well, but he's...
Come on, Josef, come on.
There it goes, and it's down 150-55 for Josef Lyre, and that tells you everything you need to know. And oh man, for Halmer, it's a big problem because he hasn't even gotten his second pocket set. The time is going to run out for him, I'm pretty sure, once it reaches 2:30.
Look at Lyre supporting Halmer though, trying to give him that motivational boost. He's up onto the second springboard at least. That's huge. This is an incredibly complex discipline.
Absolutely,
it's very possibly the most complex. And as Troy was saying,
The rookies, for example, don't even use two springboards. It's that hard. For years, until you become a pro, it's too complex even to go to the second one. So
and that's a DQ for time exceeded for Heimer. And that is really, really unfortunate because he struggled very much to get that first pocket set, and he just took too much time with setting the pockets. But this is, like you said, a very complex is actually one of the best descriptions of this discipline because there is so much going on that you have to be aware of. And everything that you do there plays a role in the safety of you being up 2 meters in the air with a razor-sharp axe in your hand.
Wow, great performance there from Lyre. He's got the best moustache in the arena, and he has currently got the best springboard time in the arena. 150.14. That'll give him 16 points. Remember, the later the discipline, the more points you get for them. So that could be very, very interesting indeed. Halmer, we said yesterday a couple of times, you win or you learn, don't you? And I'm sure Halmer will go away from this. He'll reflect, he'll go back to his training ground, and he'll learn from this, right?
Yeah, most definitely. I mean, he's not gonna walk away with this thing with, you know, a sad eye on the situation. He's gonna look at it and say, okay, what do I need to do to improve this situation? How can I get better at it? And it's really just about making sure that you've got the confidence in the pockets that you cut the first time and getting them cut as cleanly and efficiently as possible. And you can see here, he spent a lot of time trying to make sure that second pocket was absolutely perfect, which is important because in that second pocket on that second board, you're up very, very high in the air. And here, even resetting that first pocket was a big problem for him. So, you know, it was about him trying to make sure that he felt confident up there. And unfortunately for him, redoing those pockets and rechecking and rethinking the whole situation was a time killer.
It ate away the time, didn't it? It's interesting. There was clearly a decision made by the athlete there. He was up. I mean, the board wasn't as saggy as maybe sometimes you see them, but it just didn't feel right for him, did it? And when an athlete doesn't feel right, they come out again, they maybe try again, but as you said, that is what cost him those valuable seconds. We see a great close-up there of the notch of the springboard. That is an incredibly difficult pocket that you're cutting there. The angles have to be absolutely right so that your weight counterbalances against the board and conversely props you up against gravity. It's wonderful maths, but it's really difficult to get right with the axe. What we're seeing with both of them, and we saw that differently recently when we were watching some international tournaments, is that they're both quite close to the logs, right? We see the absolute top performers, the Ferry Svans and those kinds of people, slightly further away, giving them the opportunity to really swing into
That's
it, right?
Correct, yeah. But you also have to consider that the weight of the athlete is going to play a role in how they feel on that board. And if you don't have a solid board, the weight of the athlete is going to sag that board down. And, you know, you could be the most powerful guy in the world, but if your board isn't set correctly, you're not able to use that power. So it's really important to have that springboard in the right position to make sure that it's solidly locked into place. And that's, like I said, it's all about getting those pockets absolutely correctly set.
Look at that for a shot. He loved that. He enjoyed it. Let's see if the time's getting anywhere close to that in heat two, because this is Peter Rich, the 25-year-old, going up against Matthias Hinterreiter, 6 years his senior. Both personal bests nudging 2 minutes here. So this might be touch and go whether these two athletes will be able to get a score on the board here.
I think we're going to see an improved time from Peter Rich. He's been working hard in this discipline. You know, we saw him do a very, very good job in the underhand chop and the standing block chop. I think that that we're going to see an improved time and a personal best here for Peter Rich. I really hope so for both of these guys, actually. But Peter at 80 kilos is, in my opinion, has the advantage of the weight. Now, that said, we have to remember that, Matthias Hinterreiter is an experienced athlete here, and you might even say a veteran of the sport. So, you know, he's not going to let Peter Rich walk away with this one easily.
No, he's not. This might end up being an opportunity for the two of them to use the competition on the stage to improve their own technique, right?
Definitely.
As both of their personal bests are, let's be realistic, probably not going to put them among the top scorers in this discipline, then it might be an opportunity, which is a rare opportunity, particularly after the months that we've had in the last couple of years, for these two Austrian athletes to go up head head-to-head against another athlete and try and benefit from that, you know, that competition, that feeling of challenge from the other athlete just a couple of feet away from you.
Yeah, and just getting those last bit of stabilizer bars in position. They always want to wait with those last two stabilizer bars when the athlete comes out so they can check with the athlete to make sure that they put the stabilizer bar in a position that's not going to interfere or hinder their performance in any way whatsoever. But those stabilizer bars are definitely a necessity because the log is so high up there and because of so much torsional forces on the block when they are actually standing on those springboards.
Important to say, and maybe a good time to say, while we're watching the team here prepare the springboard setup, is that all of the wood that we use here at STIHL TIMBERSPORTS is sustainably sourced and delivered as much as is possible, is recycled, for example, into chipping or for other uses. So we take the use
furnace
of our wood.
Furnace
pellets, exactly, as well. We take the use and sustainability of the wood extremely seriously here at STIHL TIMBERSPORTS. We love the wood that we work with and we look after it.
And the wood that's used more often than not here is poplar wood or a white pine. So, you know, they use both, but the majority of the time it's poplar wood here on the European market.
It is still drizzling a little bit here in Vienna. Would the water that sort of collects the capillary water resting on the surface of the wood, might that affect the blows, the attack in any way?
Three, not at this point, two, no. It's one, just about grip on the axe more than anything.
Good point. Very good point. Okay, we're off in heat two. Rich going up against Hinterreiter here. The first job is to get that all-important pocket set and the springboard in so that you're up.
Rich has got a seven-hit pocket, but he got a lot of sag as he tried to get it in. So now he's going back, and Hinterreiter is already up and setting his second pocket. Look at Hinterreiter's board. It is perfectly flat. That first board is about as good as it gets. And now he's going to want to try and set that second pocket. Here comes Peter Rich. Now, Peter Rich has got a super saggy first board. But for him, the first board, it doesn't matter. He wants to make sure that second board has that up angle so that when he steps on it, it moves to flat. Now, Hinterreiter is taking quite a long time to set that second pocket, and this is the pocket that often is the determining pocket for these guys. They want to make sure that it's absolutely right. A quick sweep with his fingers to make sure that nothing's in there that's going to cause that board to slip at all. Places the board, quick test for Hinterreiter, and he moves up onto the top as they just passed
the
1 minute mark.
The crowd there,
a ginger test of the stability of the board, and he starts working at it. But you can also see that he is not all the way back on the board, so still not really trusting it. Peter Rich, he's got a sagger that's coming out there big time. He stepped back on the board and it started to go away on him. So he's going to reposition that and redo the pocket. And here is that killer situation where you've got a real problem. And I guess I misspoke saying that Peter Rich is going to have a personal best. It's not going to happen for him today here because he obviously was just not feeling confident with those pockets.
150.14, the time from Joseph Lyer to beat. We are getting close to that.
There
and
Hinterreiter
still yet to have progressed to the second side. He seems to be tiring as well. There's each hit is just draining him one final more little bit. Will he be able to finish those final blows?
He's got to get through the other side first, though, and he's got 30 seconds to do it in. As switches to the other hand and going from that awkward side there, Peter Rich is in a bit of trouble here. Will he be able to get there and under the 2:30 time limit? He's got himself a good board now, but it's not looking really good as they're passing 12:15 and Hinterreiter gets it at 12:13.97.
There is the confirmation, 2:13.97. Rich will probably time out here unless there's some kind of miracle finish. Couple of seconds to go. There it is.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, the time limit exceeded.
That's a bummer.
By Peter Rich.
So much for my call about a personal best, hey?
It was looking good until that second. I mean, look at the board now. It's absolutely plumb, isn't it?
Yeah, it's absolutely perfect. That second board
is
perfect.
He could laugh and smile about it. That's the important thing.
You know, you could pull a double pike off of that board into the pool. You know, that's how good that board
one
is
could.
At the moment.
I couldn't, but one possibly
one
could.
One could, yes. I agree with you. I'm not one of those either.
It's great that Rich was able to finish with a smile there. He knew exactly what it was what it was that stopped him. We were talking about that complexity. He just about got everything right until that last step. Matthias Hinterreiter clocks a 2:13. which at the moment is good enough for second place, and 14 tasty points. If we're going to see some DQs in this event, which looks like being the situation, then anything on the board will help you, let alone a double-figure score, right?
Absolutely. I mean, anytime you can get points and step up to the next level, that's important. And unfortunately for those guys that get DQs, it's a 0 point score, right? So that's the problem.
There's the confirmation that the time limit was exceeded by Rich. He can smile anyway, though, and the fist is pumped royally into the air by Hinterreiter, celebrating his score. 14 points will get him as we look at it from now, and it's a time of 2:13.71. It wasn't the fastest ever, but it was clean and tidy, wasn't it? He went through the motions.
Well, that was a good first board by Hinterreiter. He got it placed, and here is the first board. There's a lot of junk in that pocket.
You can see the pocket's not big enough.
Peter Rich missed the placement completely, and when he tested it, the board sagged a bit too much. Now he cleans out the pocket and doesn't bother trying the board again. He just went and started hitting again. So that was maybe the problem.
Do you think maybe he might have been able to go for that at that stage?
I kind of think so, because the pocket looked nice and tidy. Once he cleaned out and swept it out with his fingers, he probably could have tested the board and been okay. Now here on the second board from Hinterreiter, as he gets it tested really quickly, locks it into place with that big tooth on the end and gets in position. A quick
test
bounce test, as that's always important to do. It sagged a little bit, but it wasn't bad at all. And the thing is that Peter Rich's second pocket was ideal, but he just took too long to set it. A little hop of the axe there on that last bit. The thing here, though, each time that he sets his pocket, he doesn't clean it out with his hand, and there he just didn't have the stability to hold that board and put it in place. So he starts cutting the pocket again. So, and this is the thing that, and I've talked to a few of the athletes about this, it's really making sure that you feel confident with the pocket, and that's just time. That's just time and trial and practice and making sure that you get it done. And Hinterreiter with a very nice final blow to get himself.
Here it is in super slow motion.
He was happy about that one.
Look at the ecstasy go over his face here. You can hear that scream over here in the studio, and kind of a magnanimous kind of shrug of the shoulders from Rich, but he will live to see another day.
Yes.
And we will see him shortly back on the competitive circuit, hopefully getting under 2 minutes. All right, we are ready on stage for heat three of the springboard, and that will be Penker, who was leading the field for quite a while, but has slipped slightly, going up against Hermann Heiligenbrunner. We have seen two DQs so far already in the springboard. As we said, one of the most complex of the timber sports. Joseph Lyer, though, sitting atop the leaderboard on the springboard as it stands at one with a time of 1:50.14.
Stefan Penker in sixth place with 32 points at the moment, so he can gain some good points and perhaps jump up the leaderboard here with a good score in the springboard.
As we said, the first three disciplines only give you a maximum of 12 points. The fourth discipline, the single buck, gives you a maximum possible total of 16. The springboard is worth even more. So if the athletes here can clock a good time, they stand a very good chance of bumping up their score to something really quite interesting. The local Austrian moderators here really geeing up the crowd, who have stayed. I mean, the numbers haven't changed despite the weather for a couple of hours now. That's just fascinating. That's just great. That
it's
shows
amazing
how much they love the sport. It shows the local support that they've got here. And you know what? It's just great to be back, isn't it?
Yes.
Doing live events.
Live events with audiences.
Enjoying live sports, people.
It's amazing. I'll take that any day of the week.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. A lot of us have struggled some pretty difficult times over the last months, and the opportunity to wave a flag and have a shout and watch somebody stick a springboard into a tree stump. There's not much better things I can think of doing on my Sunday afternoon than that. We're loving it here.
Yeah, absolutely fantastic. Great job by these guys out there as well on the crew to make sure that deck gets changed very quickly. And I'm amazed by the efficiency that just it improves and increases from year to year. They're so quick with it now that it used to be like 7 to 10 minutes that we would have to prattle on about whatever happened to be on our minds at the time just to fill the void. And now these guys are done in between 3 and 5 minutes or less. And especially with the springboard, these things being so big, these blocks and these stands that they have to put out there, it requires quite the effort to make sure that they're very solidly placed in deck.
Dear Troy, I wouldn't call your ruminations prattling at all.
My ruminations.
We are ready for heat three of the springboard.
Go.
This is Stefan Pinker going up against Hermann Heilingenbrunner. Will we see any more DQs, or will we see times challenging Leier and Hinterreiter?
Stefan Pinker with a 4.5 hit pocket, and that board looks a bit slippery as he got up there. I don't see any grip tape on there at all. Heiligenbrunner now placing his first board. He looks confident about that as he gets up there. For a big man, he sure is spry. Pinka looking at that second pocket very intently as he taps and taps and
tap,
taps
tap,
to
tap
get it
there,
in.
There, isn't it?
Yeah, but he's got another solid
that
pocket by the looks of it.
That was a very precise technique.
Yeah, it was very precise. I mean, you're not going to see that very often getting in close like that, but he's up on that top board, and he seems pretty good with it. I'm surprised that he doesn't have any grip tape on there. I mentioned that, and that would just make the whole situation much better. The audience is absolutely cheering on Heiligenbrunner as he gets his second pocket placed. And look at that, up like a whip. No problem for the big man to get up there. And this is going to be a contest here between these two. Now take a look at the angle on Heiligenbrunner's board. It's super steep, and that's actually good for him. And if he wanted to, he could step back a little bit. Yeah, he's got a little bit more power than Pinker does, but Pinker's got a huge lead on that top block now. And Heiligenbrunner using all that energy up to try and get through as quickly and as deeply into that first side. Here comes a big slab from Pinker's
slab out there from Heiligenbrunner as well.
Yeah.
I think we're going to see a finish here, at least one from Pinker. He's close.
Yeah, he's getting really close there, and that's that awkward backhand technique. You know, he doesn't switch his hands position like we've seen with a couple of the other guys, but I think he's going to be under 2 minutes here if he can get it done. It's wiggling and waggling now. There we go. 147.09.
It's a personal best as well for Pinker.
Yeah, and that's the fastest time of the day and a personal best for Stefan Pinker. Great
job.
Can
the crowd now nudge Heiligenbrunner over the line? He looks exhausted.
He looks exhausted. He is spent. He did a great job getting those boards set, though, but he's got 30 seconds to get this done. Under 30 seconds now, so he's in a bit of trouble. He has really spent all his energy, and he's got a lot of material left on the backside of that block to get through.
Yes.
He's just in a... Yeah, I don't think he's going to make it at this point. It's passing 22-23. No, it's not going to happen for Heiligenbrunner, so there's going to be a DQ for the big man. But I'm still amazed at how well he gets up on those boards for a big guy. He is very agile.
What a wonderful reception here from the Austrian crowd for their two local boys, Heiligenbrunner and Pinker.
Three DQs, three counted times. That's going to change the leaderboard significantly here as Stefan Pinker moves back atop the leaderboard with the fastest time of the day so far, tied for Armin Kugler with 48 points, but Armin has yet to go. He's coming up in the next heat.
But a personal best there from Pinker.
Yes, great job.
Slashing over 3 seconds off Joseph Lyer's time of 150. Good enough at the moment for 16 points. Considering the three DQs, that's pretty powerful.
Yeah, it was a great job by Stefan Pinker. And, I mean, he really, really had an interesting technique for setting those pockets. The first pocket, I was going to say, is like 5.5 cuts. So 5 proper drivers and then a little half driver. And there we go.
Stand B, unfortunately. DQ, out of time.
Both. Yeah, one cut is good as we're getting the confirmation, obviously, there from Bart Janssen. So Stefan Pinker's is good. Obviously, we knew that Heiligenbrunner unfortunately exceeded the allowed time limit.
Let's take a look back here, though.
It felt like it was stamina there was the issue for Heiligenbrunner.
Definitely. I mean, he had a really good pocket. He was just a little bit later than Pinker getting that first one. And now watch Pinker on the far side of the screen there as he slips on their board a little bit because there's no sandpaper or grip tape on there, but didn't seem to bother him. Heiligenbrunner was still setting that first pocket and getting the board in place when Pinker started setting his second pocket. But look at how spry he was getting up there. And as I was saying, for a big man, that's some easy movement. Pinker, meanwhile, You know, he starts digging in there with these little tiny chip chops to get that second board placed and make sure that he had a good stand. And Heiligenbrunner's second board was absolutely fantastic, but I think he just ran out of energy at that point when he was up on the top board there, 2 meters up off the ground.
We are seeing a field-splitting event here. This is just draining. It's just absolutely exhausting
That's
for the athletes.
That's a great way to describe it, a field-splitting event. Absolutely perfect.
Thank you. It's not only power, it's not only stamina, it's not only precision, it's not only technique, it's all of them at the same time. And it's done, lest we forget, 2.5 meters off the ground. I struggle to hit the logs in my garden when I'm standing on the grass, let alone balancing on a toothpick sticking out of a pole. This is balleretic, really, from the boys. And three times on the board is great stuff.
Look at this second board from Heiligenbrunner, though. That is, I mean, that's a beauty. And if he wanted to, he could have stepped back a little farther on that board. The sag might have even tightened up the lock on the tooth a bit. But he opted to stay a little bit closer to the block. And that really, basically hamstrung his power that he was able to put into it. Meanwhile, Stefan Pinker, a few drivers on the backside with that awkward angle to finally get it done. He struggled a couple of times to get the axe out as he got it stuck. So had he not done that, he might have had a quicker time. But nevertheless, he's got a time that counts and the fastest time so far, plus a personal best. So a great job by Stefan Pinker.
So the team are working their magic on the stage again. We see them winding and screwing and drilling and moving. These are huge apparatus that they're getting on here. The Liebherr truck here, in fact, on the left-hand side, delivering. These are heavy bits of wood, aren't they? You can't get a couple of crew members to do that. You need one of those Liebherr powerhouse machines there.
Yeah, you absolutely do. And, I mean, they've got these specially designed holders, these stands for the blocks to ratchet them into place to make sure that they're really solid and they don't have any chance of moving. And then they bolt them into the deck with these specially designed underscore bolts that are drilled into these blocks that are underneath.
Let's take a look then at Heat 4. Dallinger is going to go up against Armin Kugler. Dallinger yet to clock a score. This will be the first time that he has completed a springboard in a competitive event. And what do you know? He's going up against the greatest timber sports performer in his country of all time, Armin Kugler, who, dear viewer, I don't know whether you saw that correctly when the graphic just came up. His personal best in this event is sub 1 minute. So we have seen 146, 150, and 213. If Armin Kugler gets anywhere close to his personal best here, he will be absolutely annihilating those times. This is going to be a great learning opportunity for Dallinger, and this could be really entertaining for the crowd that have stuck it out in the drizzle here for a couple of hours.
I mean, quite honestly, even if he gets third or fourth place, he's still going to move back into top spot because he's tied for the number one position with 48 points at the moment. So, you know, Stefan Pinker has 48 points, so does Armin Kugler, but Armin hasn't done this thing. So the only thing that could happen here is if Armin DQs for whatever reason.
Ooh, don't tempt fate there.
I don't want to jinx
you
the situation.
You jinxed a couple yesterday.
I did, and I don't want to do that again. But let's be honest, we got to put those bits of information out there, right?
No, that's true. We have the benefit of hindsight. We have the benefit of slow motion technology. We have the benefit of all of these wonderful stats that are prepared for us by the production team in front of us. We don't have the benefit of a springboard or an axe. That's what the athletes have got. They're out there. They are both lining up their springboards in exactly the right place. I mean, this reminds me of those scenes that I've seen over the last few days. As we've said, we've had now 5 tournaments across 3 days here, all in the Rathausplatz in Vienna, Austria. And you caught me a couple of times observing the athletes sort of pacing through their mental procedure on stage, right? And it was very interesting to see the amount of mental preparation that goes into it, but also the precision. I mean, it felt like the athletes were really trying to take a picture in their head of where their foot will go at which moment, how they will reach for their tools. Really surprised me when you think on a sort of a 33,000 feet level, you think this is all about brute force, but it's not. There's the devil's in the detail, isn't it?
It's absolutely correct. And I mean, these guys all have their routines, and their routines make them efficient and give them that confidence that they need to have, especially in a discipline like springboard. You just don't want to guess. I'll put my board here, make the cuts there. I mean, this is not something you need guesswork in. You need to definitely have a practice hand at this, ready. Definitely. Here we go.
Guess 15 feet off the ground.
Sorry. 3, 2, 1, go!
So, Gunther Dallinger against Armin Kugler.
Those short, powerful swings from Kugler look.
Yeah, and Gunther Dallinger looked at his pocket, second guesses it. One more hit, two more hits there. And Armin Kugler is up on his first board and setting his second pocket. And Gunther Dallinger opt to push his pocket over a little bit and reposition it to make sure that he's got a solid one. And Kugler's got his second board in place. It looks very good. It's not sagging at all. In fact, it's come to a flat position. Oh, but wait a minute. It is now sagging a bit, but it doesn't seem to be affecting Armin Kugler at all as he's making short work of the first side of his top block. Gunther Dallinger now trying to get that second board's pocket set and ready to go. But meanwhile, Armin Kugler just passing 45 seconds. Oh, no! Gunther Dallinger has broken a massive chunk out of that block, and he's not going to have... He's not going to have enough stability there. A whole piece of slab has come out, and that is a 55.99 time for Armin Kugler. He has done it once again. Absolutely fantastic. And Gunther Dallinger is in a bit of trouble here.
55.99.
I watched him dig a hole deeper in there, and a big slab started to break away on that bottom board as finally he seems to be pleased with the second pocket, and now he places that board. Will he have enough stability to get up there?
A finish here would be great. It doesn't matter about the time. Dallinger's never delivered a time in competition. Any time would be great.
He's got a lot of sag on that board, though, and this is what I'm talking about. Because there's so much sag, he's got to move forward. He's got to choke up on the axe a little bit, and that means he doesn't have as much power, and that means it's going to take him a lot longer to cut through that block at the top, especially seeing as he's not up as high as he would like to be. The other thing is that sagging takes away your confidence because you're always thinking in the back of your head about whether or not that is going to hold a position, because you definitely don't want to fall off that board from that height there.
The crowd giving him every possible opportunity. Yeah. They're giving him everything they've got. It doesn't look like he's going to do it on this occasion, but he's got so close, and this is such a difficult event. Armin Kugler, on the other hand, looks like he's just waiting for an Uber. I mean, just a relaxation personified. What a fine athlete this man is.
And he's giving lots of encouragement to Gunther Dallinger, but Gunther's
close,
just not going to do it, and
he's
that's
close.
That.
He was seconds away from that.
Yeah.
Great performance, great try, wonderful support from the crowd. But I'm sorry, an absolutely world-class performance from a world-class athlete, Armin Kugler.
Definitely. And I mean, it was the first... It comes down to the pocket. You overthink the pocket, and then you got to go back and you got to redo it again. It becomes a problem. And then you see the times are just getting hammered by the guys here having problems with their pockets. So that's 4 DQs and 4... registered times with Armin Kugler with the fastest time of the day. And that means Armin Kugler, Stefan Penker, 1 and 2. But the difference in points between Armin and Stefan, 64 to 46. Unbelievable.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a good third on standby. Unfortunately, in DQ.
There's the confirmation
out of
from
five.
The referee, Bart Janssen. Dallinger picks up a DQ, and Kugler with that ridiculously fast 55.76, which is good enough for first place in that discipline and good enough for first place in the overall standings. We'll just see a couple of slow motion shots here of that all-important pocket.
I believe this is Gunther Dallinger. He looked at it and he didn't like it. What's really important here is, and I hope we get to see this, he put the pocket a little bit farther over. He moved it over to his left a little bit more. Now watch what happens when he places the board and tests it. It almost slabs the block that, or the stand that he's standing on, and you can see the thing. He starts to sag it down, and he just didn't have the stability, and then the board came out and pulled a big chunk of that main tree stand out. Here it comes. Oh, we don't get to see it. Ah, too bad. But there's,
I mean,
the
second
board.
Look at the cleanliness
board.
Of that pocket, though. It looked that like it had been, you know, carved out with a
laser
fine
cut. I mean, you know, his board started off well, Armin Kugler's did, and started to sag a little bit, but he said, you know what, I don't care, I'm going to keep going here, and that's really what he had to do. He had no choice if he wanted to get a good time. He just had to keep going at it. But look at the board here, that second one, or that first one, just sagging and sagging and sagging.
All right, we've seen little slip there right at the
scary
end, but we've seen some great performances. We've seen some tries. We've seen four DQs and four times. It really did split the field there, the springboard. We've got one more discipline to come, and that is the hot saw, and that is just fantastic. Every metalhead's dream. Talking of metalheads, I hope that we can go over to the arena to speak to my two favorite Austrians. Hopefully Florty is there with Joseph Lyer. Yeah, it's going to take a couple more seconds, but we'll see the springboard graphic here first of all. Kugler with a time of 55.76, confirming what we heard. The only other three finishers were Penker, Lyer, and Hinterreiter. That helps propel them to a overall standing position of Kugler in first place, Penker second with 46, Lyer
in third.
Third place of 45.
Very good.
And my question is whether we can have a chat with Lyer, because we said that he started quite slowly, but he really seems to be
ramping it up now with the hot saw. It's all make or break with the hot saw. So, yeah, it's going to be interesting to see what happens with this next discipline. But first...
Yeah, there they are. It looks like Joseph is standing on a box. I think that's very unfair. I wonder whether you could ask our dear friend here, Joseph, if he could tell us how he feels, particularly because we felt that he started slowly into the competition, but he really seems to be moving forwards now.
Yeah, very much looks like it. He's on position three at the moment, only 1 point behind the silver medalist. Josef, die Jungs haben gesagt, du hast relativ langsam angefangen und dich immer mehr gesteigert zu einem sehr guten Zeitpunkt. Siehst du das ähnlich wie Matt und Troy?
Ja, wenn ich jetzt arrogant wäre, würde ich sagen, ich habe den Jungs eine Chance gelassen. Aber nein, es war nicht mehr drinnen am Anfang. Ich kann es dir nicht sagen, was das Problem war. Es war einfach halt, das Holz, die Technik nicht richtig rausgehackt. Da habe ich gedacht, so... Jetzt geht's entweder schief oder wir schaffen es nochmal rauf.
Und die Hot Saw, die jetzt kommt, das ist ja bekanntlich der Maker or the Breaker. Da geht's um alles, da geht's um die Medaillen.
Ja, natürlich, aber Hot Saw ist einfach geil.
Ja, und das wissen wir hier auch. Es wird extrem laut und es ist jetzt schon so laut, dass du fast meine Fragen nicht hören kannst. Deswegen nur mal eine einzige. Du warst gestern und vorgestern für uns im Studio. Was hat dich mehr gestresst? Das Kommentieren oder hier diesen Wettkampf zu bestreiten?
Du, das hat beides einen Reiz, ob du jetzt dann auf der Bühne stehst, drinnen ist schwer, wenn du denkst, hey, ich will mitmachen, ich will in das Geschehen eingreifen. Wenn du draußen stehst, denkst du, naja, das war aber auch gemütlich.
Viel Glück fürs große Finale. Vielen, vielen Dank.
Danke.
Back to you guys.
Thank you very much, Florty, and thank you, Joseph. Roughly translated, Joseph said that he doesn't want to be arrogant. He didn't deliberately start slowly to give others a chance, but he's very
possum.
Pleased with his performance so far. And there were apologies, obviously, for the loud noises in the background. They are preparing the hot saw, which is quite a machine if you haven't seen it before. That's why you could hear those noises in the background. But he certainly said that he's enjoying it, and he's very proud and very much looking forward to going through to that final discipline. Let's take a look at this leaderboard as it stands, because there will be a change coming up.
Yeah, this is the point where we lose a few guys now. This is the one point where, you know, we have two guys that will drop out of the hot saw competition, so only six will proceed to the final discipline, which is hot saw. And for all of you gas heads out there, this is definitely your discipline. It's super fun.
So, we have the graphic now. Let's go to it. And this is the leaderboard as it stands. Kugler is in first place with a pretty much unassailable 64 points. Penker in second with 46. Lyer, who we just saw in the interview, very good standing of third place with 45 points. Dalinger, 41. And Heiligenbrunner with 40 points. That means that Hinterreiter, Heiligenbrunner, Dalinger, Lyer, Penker, and Kugler will qualify for the last event. That is the hot saw, and the two bottom listed, unfortunately, will be going home. That's Heiligenbrunner and Dallinger. I think they've had a good day. I beg your pardon. That is Rich and Halmer, excuse me. They've had a good day. They've had the opportunity to share the stage with an expert. Let's go and share the stage with those experts and with those tools.
Thank you.
These custom, handmade race tune machines are built for maximum power and precision and to cut the wood as fast as possible in a competition. They are built with a 60 to 80 horsepower single-cylinder two-stroke engine, often taken from a snowmobile or high-powered motorbike. The hot saw can weigh up to 30 kilograms, and its chain rotates at over 250 kilometers an hour. The cost of a competition hot saw used in STIHL TIMBERSPORTS is upward of 6,000 euros. Hot saw. For the hot saw, power saws are called into action, and the athletes have a space of 15 centimeters to cut three complete discs off a 46 centimeter thick wooden block. Jumping the start or cutting over the line will result in a disqualification.
This is the final discipline. It's the hot saw, and it is hot and spicy, I'm telling you. It's going to see Hinterreiter in heat one against Heiligenbrunner. Then we are going to see Dallinger versus Leier in heat two and Penker versus Kugler in heat three. These machines are brutes. You cannot, and I'm not exaggerating here, you cannot get within 30 feet of it without having to put your fingers in your ears.
Yeah, absolutely. They are very loud, they're very powerful, they're very dangerous, they're also very finicky. So the thing is that the difference here is they'll get a chance to warm up the saws. You'll hear the judges on stage say, okay, warm up your saws. Here we go. And you'll get them started.
Okay, gentlemen.
And what they do is they warm up the saws to heat up the engine a little bit so that when they do the cold start, it's not really a cold start anymore. The other thing is they call this the make or break discipline, so it's still all or nothing. So it could be that because the most points are to be won here in this discipline, if you have a fast time, you could still win the competition.
That's a good point. It's a very good point.
Yeah.
Right, we've got heavy metal music playing, we've got heavy metal instruments on the stage, we've got heavy metal safety equipment separating the athletes.
Seconds.
This is rock and roll, dear viewers. This is the hot saw, this is heat number one, this is Hinterreiter versus Heiligenbrunner.
And by the way, folks, don't blink.
Thought you were going to say don't try this at home.
I'm not hoping that we'll see finickiness because I always want to see these athletes succeed,
athletes
but I will
ready.
Explain the finicky aspect
stand
if something does happen. I'll
timber.
Give you the heads up here.
Three, two,
it's Fast and
one,
Furious. This
go.
Is the hot saw.
Oh,
Heiligenbrunner got stuck there on the second upstroke, didn't he? But he's through. 8.71 against Hinterreiter's 9.11. Personal best for Heiligenbrunner. Brilliant
stuff. That is a fantastic cut from him and Heiligenbrunner. For Matthias Hinterreiter on his second, second, I believe it was second one, he chipped the top, so he had to reset.
Do we think that might even be an infraction?
No,
that
I don't
would be
think
graded
so.
Against by the referees?
I don't think so. He reset and he got a clean cut, and I believe so, and I don't see any flag on the play at all there, so I think we should be safe for both of these guys.
Yeah,
and
we saw that kind of...
It looks like Bart is coming down to the decision stage anyway, so that
I
means there's
I think I
no
saw the sort of
problem.
Divers, oh, everything's okay kind of hand signal from Bart, so that looks good. There was a slight hitch from Hinterreiter on the second upstroke.
Oh,
he still came through with a good time. They're both good. Hinterreiter 8.99. And look at that, the personal best from Heiligenbrunner celebrating with his local crowd.
Having some fun. That's good. Love to see that.
59. These boys won't be walking home with the title today, but they will be walking home as local heroes. Thumbs up all round. Well then, gentlemen, your day is over. Your tournament is over. Two cracking times to set us off in the last discipline here.
Hermann Heiligenbrunner does move up into second place overall, but let's see what that means for him once Gunther Dallinger and Josef Leier have both had their cuts. Now, you can see here Heiligenbrunner with a really beautiful start here. That's a good first cut. That's a beautiful cookie. On the upstroke, that's another good one. Here, it's the downstroke. He skips a little bit, and yep, that's going to be a reset.
That.
And then he's got to make that third cookie. So he still did it, and that probably shaved off, of, or not shaved off, added on about, you know, 3/4 of a second.
Very possibly.
That's a difference maker in these.
Very possibly. And we saw there in Heiligenbrunner as well, in the second upstroke, you see the incredible power that these machines have got.
Yes.
And where it nudged, and the, when you think about the blade going at 250 miles an hour, it skipped off the surface of the log. And if you're not an extremely strong man, you could lose control of the machine.
Yeah, time. And that's the thing, right? You know, there's a lot of machinery moving there, and there's a lot of centrifugal force. So having good control of these very powerful and very dangerous machines is very important.
This is heat two. This is Gunter Dallinger going up against Joseph Lyer. Dallinger is probably out of the medal contention, but Lyer is very much in the with a shout here. If he can clock a good hot saw time, and remember, there's only six left in the competition. Down, up, down. If it can be sub 9 seconds, sub 9.5 seconds, this might get him on the podium.
Yeah, prior to this discipline, Josef was sitting in third place, so he's in a good stead. Look at the two different blade types here
gentlemen.
As well. Josef has a straight blade, and there's a little bit more of a thicker blade through the middle on Gunter Dallinger's saw. You can also see these glass panels that they've set up between the athletes and on the backside of each athlete there. Those are more or less bulletproof panels to make sure that no items can fly through and hit somebody or hit another athlete while they're doing these cuts. Now, traditionally, this event has been the athlete on stage by himself, so that ups the ante a little bit more because the other guys get to watch the heats, but now they've opted for two on stage for efficiency's sake, which is also quite interesting because you've got that adrenaline factor playing
yeah,
again.
Yeah, you do. You got that competitive edge. All right, the hands already on the log from Dallinger. Lyer.
Athletes,
his
ready.
Hands are on as well. He's wearing
Stand
the gloves. Dallinger without
timber.
The gloves. This
Three,
is heat two. Everything
one,
to play
go.
For, particularly for Lyer, and they are off. Both machines up and running. And Lyer through with a 7.21.
Oh, yeah.
Look
personal
at that, the personal
Joseph
best.
Lyer. He hovered a little bit to get on top, but he has three good cuts, and he is happy about that. He went
another
over and checked himself.
Best.
And Gunter Dallinger with a 14 and change. He's going to take that person. Oh, no, but he's got a cutout. That is unfortunate. That is not a complete cookie unless they can match up that extra piece there and make sure that you've got a... Yeah, maybe. Maybe he's okay. They're going to look very closely at this, but it does not appear to be a complete cookie.
No,
so
doesn't.
From my perspective and also from the perspective of Bart Janssen, I'm imagining that he's going to say, no, that's a DQ because that was a big cutout there. So that they're going to have to make sure. So missing a chunk there, so there's going to be a lot of discussion there. It's a little bit like putting a puzzle back together to make sure that they're safe. Let's see.
Let's have a very close look at this. So
yeah, I mean,
the question here is whether that piece originated from that cookie. If it did and it broke off as it fell, then it'll be allowed to stand. But if it is considered a separate piece, then it won't be. The other three... Very quick cursory look. Here he's looking at the bottom to see if the blue line has been covered. We're not getting any conclusive feedback from
Joseph
Bart Janssen's body language
confident,
here.
Though. Joseph seems pretty confident. He checked himself to make sure that blue line was not cut over, and I think we're going to have a decision now.
Joseph, you're right, does seem happy with it. Here we go. 7.21 as it stands. Will it be given? Bart playing the crowd well here. Building the drama. And that high five was for me. He seems confident. He's shaking his legs here. But there seems to be communication between the referees.
We are checking a video.
There is a video check. I can confirm that there will be a video check.
And I have not three complete discs. I'll be checking what happened. But it's close. We will see.
So the video check is running currently. That is why we still don't have...
Santo, good?
Stand one, DQ, incompleted.
The confirmation that, unfortunately, it was a DQ for Dallinger, but Joseph Lyer, he's absolutely ecstatic about that.
That's 7.2. A fantastic cut as well. Fastest cut so far today.
Fastest cut today, and the fastest cut he has ever done, 7.24.
So that puts some pressure on Stefan Penka and Armin Kugler to come on and perform. Now let's take a look at these cuts here. There is the cutout.
Yeah, you can see the cutouts. Yeah. But that's okay if he stops and goes again, right?
He can stop and go again. The problem is having a complete cookie, and there's a little bit of a tap. This is all about, having that confidence and having that knowledge of your machine and really knowing the ins and outs of it. So it's about time and effort and training here. And look at this. These three cuts from Josef Lyer are just fantastic. Great flow, great speed.
All three of them, so much flow.
Just fantastic.
It didn't feel like one was faster than the other. All three had the same kind of pace and feel about them, didn't they?
Yeah, and I mean, smooth is clean, clean is fast.
So Josef Lyer currently in second place with 63 points. Heiligenbrunner and Hinterreiter, who have already been with 55 and 51 respectively. That means that Penka, should he clock a good score here, he should be able to jump above Josef Lyer into second place. But as I'm reading this now, Josef Lyer is guaranteed at least third, and Armin Kugler is guaranteed at least second. I beg your pardon. I think that's right. We will
worst
have that double checked.
Worst case scenario.
Of course.
I mean, if Josef can stay in the top spot with those 18 points, then he will have 64 points. So we'll see what kind of a score that will come out of this. But I'm pretty sure that Armin Kugler is going to walk away with this one without too many problems at all. But again, this is a very finicky discipline, and anything can happen. You know, you've seen already a DQ, and the rest can be about problems with starting the saw.
Remember, Kugler won't know those exact numbers, so he'll just know that he wants to get the fastest time that he possibly can. He can't be risking.
That's
with
all he's focusing on at this point.
Exactly. The heavy metal music is playing. That's the sign that we're ready for the hot saw again. They've warmed up their machines. They're just putting the drawstrings on to get themselves set. And then
30 seconds.
Troy has already told you, don't blink, dear viewer. Anything 7, 8, 9 seconds, this is a goner.
You can see that carabiner attached to the pull handle there, because the guys actually just throw away the start cable, so they don't want to throw it too far away, so they attach a carabiner so that if it doesn't start properly, they can draw it back in, rewrap, and start again.
Athletes, ready!
The mobile phones are out, trying to capture the moment. This might be the moment where I got to film the Austrian champion. Kugler, down, up, down, third one, 6.73.
Oh, wow, a great time for Kugler. A personal best for Armin Kugler of a 6.73. That's a definite winning. That's a winning fist pump right there. They'll check those discs right away to make sure that everything is all good. That was a really good couple of discs by Stefan Penka as well. He had an 8.59. So the top four guys all got personal bests here. Kugler, Lyer, Penka, and Heiligenbrunner. Fantastic results for all of them, and Armin Kugler, happy about that. We can now provisionally say he is remaining as the Austrian national champion. Eighth time in a row for him. It's just about the confirmation here from Bart Janssen.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, both cuts are good.
Both cuts are good. There it is, the hands in the air. And that is the confirmation that for the eighth year in a row, the Austrian professional timber sports champion is Armin Kugler.
But another great performance by Stefan Penka, who is going to be the bronze medalist today. And our man, Josef Lyer, he's going to take away the silver with a fantastic hot saw as well.
And Stefan Penka is, as it stands, no, as it stands, there is no as it stands. Stefan Penka will take the third place. We're going to see a head-to-head between Kugler and Lyer in a split screen, so we can see those two sub 8-second turns right up against each other. 6.74 was the time from Kugler. Laia put up a 7.24. You are right. You blink and you miss it in this event, don't you?
Yeah, this discipline is just so quick. It happens so fast. And look at that beautiful targeting by Armin Kugler. A great job by him. And here we see the saw from Stefan Pinker. Also nice and smooth, very stable, very quick. No mistakes on the draws or the pushes through. So great job by both of these guys to have absolutely fantastic cuts and perfect cookies.
Look at the sawdust, absolutely scattered hither and thither. He knew it right away. That was his personal best.
Yes.
For a man who's won the championship 7 times, he still did that the fastest he's ever done it. And that's what it makes him feel like. These are the confirmations of the hot saw scores. Dallinger didn't finish. Hinterreiter had an 8.99. Heilingenbrunner slightly faster, 8.59. Four of the top five were personal bests. And that means that the Austrian Pro Championship 2002 winner will be Armin Kugler. Second place will go to Josef Laia. And Penker will be in third with 58 points.
Yeah, fantastic results for these guys, in particular Armin Kugler, 8 times in a row. I mean, that's just fantastic. And he it's weird. He seems to improve from year to year. So it's going to be it's a fantastic result for him, and he's going to be over the moon about that. Absolutely fantastic today. Great job.
He really is. I mean, we talked about Armin being the favorite from the beginning of the event, and he followed through on that. You know, he delivered. But I'm particularly happy for Laia and Penker because they're going up against the best of the best here in Austria, and they went toe-to-toe with him.
Yeah, they did a great job, absolutely. And, I mean, you know, they can be proud of how they performed today. So congratulations to all those three guys. Very nicely done.
Okay, what is also nicely done is the team that has organized the award ceremony on the stage behind us. So we are going to go live to Florty in the arena for the award ceremony. Here we go.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it is time for the official winner ceremony of the Austrian Pro Championship 2022. Machen wir Lärm für alle Athleten, die heute hier am Start waren. Unter anderem Manuel Haumann, Peter Ritsch, Günther Dallinger, Matthias Hinterreiter und Hermann Heiligenbrunner. And that brings us to the top three. Wir kommen zu den ersten drei. Die Bronzemedaille mit großartigen 58 Punkten geht an Stefan Pinker. Und die Bronzemedaille wird überreicht von Alexander Hembach, General Manager STIHL Austria, der Geschäftsführer von STIHL Österreich, überreicht hier die Medaillen. Und damit sind wir auch schon bei der Silbermedaille hier bei den österreichischen Staatsmeisterschaften. Und jetzt darf es hier in der STIHL Timbersports Arena vor dem Rathaus nochmal so richtig laut werden. Ladies and Gentlemen, the silver medal goes to Josef Laia!
Stefan Pinker taking his congratulations as his third place medal on the podium. And there, the second place winner is confirmed. That's Josef Laia.
War heute wieder einmal nicht zu schlagen. Der Seriensieger, the man, the myth, the legend. Hier kommt der Staatsmeister 2022, Mr. Armin Kugler.
And the STIHL Timbersports Austrian Pro Champion for the 8th year in a row is the remarkable Armin Kugler. Florty confirming on stage here that he was the favourite, he was defending his title, but he delivered, and he delivered in style. There it is. That is the trophy which will be handed over by the general manager of STIHL Austria, Alexander Hembach. Beautiful design there. He's seen it before, but he still enjoyed taking hold of that, didn't he? Held aloft in front of the Rathaus here in Vienna, Austria, the 2022 Austrian Pro Timber Sports Champion, Armin Kugler. And we're going to hear the Austrian national anthem of Austria. And this is our favourite bit, the fireworks and the champagne. Here it comes!
Absolutely drenched, Kugler, right away.
It's not as if it isn't wet out there already.
Yeah.
But those three know that they were in a battle today, and they certainly deserve a little drink, and they certainly deserve the fireworks and the applause that they're getting. We have had an absolutely cracking day here in Vienna. STIHL Timbersports does it again, the fifth of five tournaments here over the weekend, giving us personal bests, giving us records, giving us another world Austrian championship for Armin Kugler.
Fantastic result there for all of these guys on the podium, but a great, great, great job. I mean, it looked at though at one point as though Armin might be struggling a little bit.
There were
he
blips.
Was down in the bottom of the list there, and blip is the right way to say it, because he erased those blips fairly quickly and came back with a vengeance to take the title one more time.
Here's Austrian fans who stayed to the bitter end here in, what can be best described as autumnal weather here in Vienna.
Inclement conditions.
Loved it, and that it was worth hanging around for what really can only be described as a living legend in this sport,
yes,
in this country.
Yes, one of them definitely.
You're seeing here, going across the bottom of the screen, 2022, the World Championships are back, dear viewer. It'll be in Gothenburg, Sweden this year. Tickets are still available for the team World Championships and for the individual World Championships. We'll be there. We hope that you will be too. We have loved getting back to live events and seeing STIHL Timbersports back on the road, and we are continuing on the road all through the year. We are going to be able to get the eight-time Austrian champion Armin Kugler into the studio here for a little interview. So we're going to shuffle him up here. He will conduct the interview in German, and I will do my best to translate for you. He's going to have a smile on his face, I think, and he's going to bring the trophy with him. Here we see him. Last high five from one of his fans here, coming up the steps, entering into the studio. The eight times Austrian champion, Armin Kugler. Come in, Armin. There you are, sir. Yeah, please. Komm rein, bitte. Ja, ich nehme das. I'll take the trophy and put it here for you. He's getting
Thank
his
you.
Headphones. Wunderbar, Armin Kugler. Achtmal, jetzt zum achten Mal österreichischer Meister. Was ist das für ein Gefühl?
Ja, es ist ein großartiges Gefühl, heute vor dem extrem coolen Publikum hier wieder zu gewinnen, die Leistungen abzurufen. Ich bin eigentlich mit fast allen Disziplinen zufrieden heute und habe alles abrufen können, was ich trainiert habe.
I asked him how it felt to be the 8-time champion here in Austria, and he said here in front of this incredible crowd, it was absolutely fantastic. He said that he was quite content with most of his performances today. Du hast die verschiedenen Disziplinen da erwähnt. Gab es so einen Tiefpunkt oder warst du mit allen zufrieden?
Ja, mit der Stoxo war ich nicht zufrieden, aber das werde ich nie sein. Das ist nicht meine Lieblingsdisziplin. Aber alles andere war eigentlich ganz in Ordnung.
Yeah, I asked him if he was pleased with all of his performances today. He said the stock saw wasn't his best, but he's never happy with that. He doesn't like that. That's not his favorite. But the rest pulled through. Die andere Athleten heute, es gab sehr, sehr viele PBs, es gab sehr, sehr viele tolle Leistungen. Was sagst du zu den anderen Wettbewerben hier?
Ja, ich bin sehr stolz auf meine Kollegen. Also es haben sich alle extrem hart vorbereitet für diese große Bühne hier in Wien. Und sie konnten eigentlich im Großen und Ganzen alle ihre Leistungen abrufen und haben sich super präsentiert.
Wunderbar. I asked him what he thought of the field, the competitors that went up against him, and he said that the pressure was there all the time. They put a great performance in, particularly in front of this crowd. Maybe that could be the last question I could ask. Du hast schon das Publikum hier erwähnt. Die sind hier über das ganze Wochenende erschienen. Die haben nicht nur die österreichische, sondern internationale Wettbewerbe hier wirklich toll und laut unterstützt. Deine letzte Worte für das Wiener Publikum hier.
Ja, vielen Dank an euch, dass ihr auch heute ausgeharrt habt, bei dem nicht ganz perfekten Wetter so zahlreich erschienen seid. Das war echt großartig. Danke.
Beautiful. I asked him what he wanted to say. Yeah, and you can hear them clapping in the background. What he wanted to say to the Austria fans here, and he said they were fantastic. He thanks them all from the bottom of his heart for coming out and supporting him. Armin Kugler, 8-time Austrian champion. Congratulations, my friend.
Thank you.
Wunderbar. Take your trophy. Last thumbs up. I will take the headset from you. Wonderful. Careful with the cable. I can confirm, dear viewers, that he absolutely stinks of champagne. So he definitely won. He is not an imposter. He is the gentleman that we just saw getting absolutely splashed on stage. Why don't we check out some final clips of the day as the winner walks past the camera. And that, dear Timbersports fans, was the Austrian Championships 2022. Oh, yes. We hope you enjoyed it. The rain didn't seem to stop, but we didn't care about that. PBs were tumbling. Great performances were there to be had. And we saw an 8-time winner in Armin Kugler.
Fantastic job. Absolutely fantastic.
I've had a blast. We hope that you've had a blast. My huge thanks to my co-coms. It was a pleasure and a joy and an honor to work with one of the greats of the industry.
For me Thank as you, well. Troy. Thank you so much.
Thank you to Florty out there in the pouring rain. Oh. We will get you a warm drink, I promise you. Thank you to all the wonderful crowds here over the whole weekend in Vienna. And thank you for looking after us. We will see you on the road, STIHL Timbersports, in the coming months and at the very latest of the World Championships in Gothenburg. But for now, from all of us here in Vienna, look after yourselves. Stay safe. Take care and bye-bye.
Ciao, everyone. See you later.